And we're here, IWA Mid South, the first ever Prince of the Deathmatch tournament. We got Dixieland Destroyer and Marcus Crane. I am Matt Cage, your high class hero. And I'm going it alone for the time being. And apparently, I'm going to be joined with our wonderful ring announcer, Mr. Jay Bullock.
Thank you, Matt Cage. It's good to be on commentary for the first time, man.
So, I just want to take credit for bringing Marcus Crane to IWA Mid-South. And I also want to take credit for Dixieland Destroyer's success. I mean,
you were in that infamous eight-man tag that stole the show at your tryout.
Indeed, I was. And quite honestly, despite the fact that I'm a big fan of Marcus Crane.
Is that a spike in his hand?
I'm not sure.
I know that's a lot of barbed wire in his back.
Now, Marcus Crane, he's a little bit sick, twisted, and perverted. He's a crazy, crazy human being, and that's why I brought him to IWA. If you remember in Addison.
Oh, yes, I was there.
We were unsuccessful in our attempt to defeat Ryan Phoenix and Bucky Collins. Now, see, Dixieland Destroyer is going to maim Marcus Crane right now.
Oh! Right in the face, Matt.
Barbed wire bat in the face. I wonder if what.
Oh, good.
I think he's tangled. He's tangled.
Oh, jeez. I think he might. That's not a good place to have barbed wire. I think he might have gotten around the eyes, could have gotten around the nose.
Now, Marcus Crane is, I believe he was once called the human hate disease.
Yes, I do recall that. I've been around for a while, and I do recall him being called the human hate disease. I remember, what the heck is Dixie doing?
Dixieland Destroyer is also another perverse man. I'm not a big fan of Dixieland Destroyer,
God.
But at the same
time. Oh my God!
Now that is almost 500 pounds of mammoth girth of girth
that
in the face
of
Marcus
Crane. That is one big turn. Oh my! Is that a headbutt? Uh-oh. Dueling headbutt.
Now Marcus Crane, I'm not sure. I think he might be Samoan. He could be Samoan. Now, Marcus Crane, I think Dixieland Destroyer has barbed wire stuck to his backside.
Uh-oh. I think he's going to powerbomb him in that stack right there. Barbed wire.
The Dixieland Destroyer has been here. He's had hellacious battles with... Right in the happy bits.
This is legal.
Bringing the Bellevue crowd to their feet.
Uh-oh. I think he's seen his own blood, and I don't think he likes it. Backhand.
Back fist to the future.
Uh-oh. What's Crane up to? Drags him over to the corner. Could be going for like a face buster? Dixie cuts him off. Oh!
Chucks him across the ring. Now, Marcus Crane is going to have to use some of his...
Oh my goodness!
Marcus Crane is going to have to bring some of that intensity that he brings to the ring on a regular basis, that crazed nature, to defeat Dixieland Destroyer, if he can. Dixieland Destroyer is 400 pounds.
So a power game, I guess, definitely would be out.
This barbed wire madness, Dixieland Destroyer is ripping away at Marcus Crane right now.
Oh, my.
And I believe he has busted open those...
Oh my! Belly to belly suplex with barbed wire!
This could be over. Barely rolling the shoulder up.
I think that was instinct, either that or the pain of just making the strike up to the sky.
Now Dixieland Destroyer and Marcus Crane in this barbed wire madness.
Get that bat! Right into the head and the shoulder blade of Marcus Crane. But he fights right back right to the hips. This time to the guts! Down to the head! Oh my God! Dixieland, I think he's bleeding from his hand at least. No way! No! This is not right!
Shades of Chris Benoit! If he just taps out, unlike the family, he may still be together, and I will probably get in so much trouble for saying that.
This is gonna be a huge upset if he gets this win. I mean, oh my!
There's nothing more than I enjoy. I know. Did you hear that? There's nothing more than I like than two crazy maniacs coming into Bellevue, Illinois on a cold Friday night and killing each other with barbed wire. I'm not sure what's gonna happen here. Marcus Crane is sick, twisted, and perverted. Marcus Crane would rape his own mother and not use a condom. Oh God.
That's kind of grisly. Oh no, no.
Oh!
Bonsai drop from
that
the
is
distance.
A lot of weight.
Can we call that a bonsai drop?
That is a lot of weight. That's what I'm calling it.
Oh my, oh no. He's got that board of barbed wire.
These two are kicking things off the right way.
Oh no. He might be going for that. He's going up. I thought he was going to go for that senton of his, but he's going up. He's going way up.
Dixieland Destroyer, he might be hitting that splash. He could be looking for the splash. Hell, for all I know, he could be looking for a swanton bomb. Marcus Crane broke free of the barbed wire, and he's dishing out these forearms. Marcus Crane is not a fan favorite, but his effort is bringing his effort
Swift
in this match.
Kick to the face.
His effort is bringing the crowd to their feet.
Uh-oh. Readjusts it. What's he
this could
here?
Not end well. I have no faith.
I think he's going to do a Hurricane Rana. Uh-oh. Tried it.
Oh,
he got
God.
It. He got it with... Oh, no. No, 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 no. Oh, wait a minute. He's double-decking this one.
Marcus Crane is going up top. What's happening here?
Oh! Swanton!
This has got to be it. This has got to be it.
Oh, my God, he wins.
And in the first ever Prince of the Deathmatch tournament, the first round match, Marcus Crane, the crazed, sick, twisted, perverted freak, defeats the Dixieland Destroyer in tomorrow night in Litchfield, Illinois. He gets his shot at Ryan Phoenix for the Light Heavyweight Championship if he can retain.
Touching me! Sweet Caroline! Oh! the death match. I am the king of the death match. Neil Diamond Cutter. I am insulting Neil.
Before we get started, I have to beg Smart Mark Video to keep John Moxley's entrance in the DVD.
And I'm also going to have to ask for a little introduction. Come on, Matt Cage, give me a little introduction here.
Well, right here joining me is... Sorry. Right here joining me, ladies and gentlemen, is the man, the myth, the legend. He is not next. He is right now. Nick Brubaker.
That is an appropriate introduction. I appreciate it, Matt. All right, now what do we got on our hands here?
We've got the first ever, to my knowledge, because I don't think anyone besides Ian Rotten is as twisted and sick and perverted to come up with something known as the Kurt Hennig Drunken Taipei Deathmatch.
That just sounds terrible.
Now, in this match, we have John Moxley already gargling shots of Jack Daniels, and we have that little poor... from the other side of the tracks, freak who defeated me to get in this match, to get in this tournament, Neil Diamond Cutter.
You sound a little bitter there, Matt.
I hate Neil Diamond Cutter. I hate his stupid new little gear. I hate his red little boots. I hate his stupid little glasses and his stupid little nipples. I hate it all. I hate everything about him.
Even his nipples. That's interesting that you'd point that out.
I hate his stupid little Brock Lesnar tattoo on his back. I hate everything about him.
That was dangerously close to that. Those broken glass. Dangerously close.
And why the hell did Neil Diamond Cutter bring a box of diapers full of glass to this match, too? Yeah, why is that?
I don't really understand the diaper box either.
He's a blithering idiot.
Moxley is wasted. I mean, he is just smashed. And he called him a... I don't want to repeat it.
I would say, under normal circumstances, I would love to have some of what Moxley has had, but I'm a man of class. I like white wines and nothing like Jack Daniels. That's
you sound like a chick right now, dude.
I'm not a chick. I'm a man of class and dignity.
Oop. I think Mox has got him here. His test of strength is not going the little man's way. Oh, no.
There's no way that little twerp is going to find a way to defeat John Moxley.
Moxley barely able to stand up at this point. That man is wasted.
Maybe if he passes out, he could pass out on Neil.
Peppering him with some shots. He's got the drunk man stumbling.
Now, have you yourself ever been in a Taipei death match?
I myself have never been and will never be. Oh my gosh, and that's exactly why I was going to say I have not and never will be in a death match.
Now,
it's never.
Now, last month in Bellevue, I took on that little moron, Neil Diamond Cutter, in an unlucky 13 staple gun death match. and the winner was to gain entry in this tournament. And that piece of garbage stapled $7 to my forehead. Now, my theme song says, money, that's what I want. And for the first time, I did not want money.
Oh, and Moxley has taken another shot. He's still standing, though. He's still standing. Maybe not for long. He's using the ropes.
I think Moxley just spit that Jack Daniels on that Vince Russo lookalike in the front row.
Here we go.
Now, I'm not sure. Do you have to pass out to win this match? What are the rules here?
What a cheater.
He cheated. Did you see that?
Hey.
Did you see that? He threw the Jack Daniels on the floor.
If the ref doesn't see it.
Oh, what a power.
You know how it works.
Oh, I hate. This is unfair. This is unjust, uncalled for. Come on. Tracy Smothers right there. And I'm a big fan of Tracy Smothers.
I'm sure you are.
Oh!
Oh!
That's right, Mox. Rip him limb from limb.
No, that is barbed wire, folks.
You know, I've never ever said I wanted someone to die, but I don't care. I want Neil Diamond Cutter to become deceased in this ring.
I think you're going to get your wish here. I don't even know how he's getting to his feet so quick here. This is an impressive showing by the little man. And Mox falls off the top rope.
Drunken buffoon, get to your feet. Murder Neil Diamond Cutter. Sweet Caroline by Neil Diamond Cutter. And it only gets one. I hate Neil Diamond.
Mox has got the glass. Oh, no. Oh, no. Rubbing it all in his grill.
All in his grill. Maybe it'll scrape some of the unbrushed plaque off of his teeth. I hate Neil Diamond Cutter.
Scrape a lot more than plaque off his teeth. That was serious. And now he's using the
I hope Neil Diamond Cutter dies right now.
Oh, no.
Have you ever had barbed wire in your face?
Absolutely.
Would you like to?
No! What kind of a question is that?
The only reason why I ask is because the only person I would like to see barbed wire in their face, ripping their eyes out of their sockets, is Neil Diamond Cutter, right now.
You are getting your wish right now. Oh no, more shots.
Oh,
what's that
microphone?
One song? That one song, the shot song. How's that one go? Shots. I don't think he's even comprehend.
John Moxley is completely gone. He's not.
Right, Neil,
I think he's more concerned. What is he doing? Square dancing?
He did an Irish jig of some sort. Or something. What's he doing?
Oh, that is. He did it again.
There you go.
He dumped out the liquor. This is not right. I really hope Neil Diamond Cutter dies. This gentleman.
That's serious.
I hope Moxley blisters Neil Diamond Cutter's.
Oh!
I hope he blisters his areolas. I'm telling you right now.
You really have an obsession with this man's nipples, but right now, the damage is all done to his back.
Yes!
No!
Yes!
Oh my
yes!
God. That's real, folks.
I think I just had an orgasm.
As real as it gets.
I just got there.
Luckiest man on earth.
In the words of Ernest the Cat Miller, somebody call that man's mama. He's gotta be in pain right now.
Never have those words rang so true as right now.
I think John Moxley is completely obliterated right now.
Yeah, he's annihilated basically. I'm
Still
surprised
miss.
He's even walking.
No.
That was a chair right at his face.
John Moxley
right at his face.
Is very unorthodox right now.
Is that the best you have right now, unorthodox? The man is wasted and he's just throwing chairs at people.
I believe that's gimmick infringement. Sabu is on the show tonight.
I think that's, you have a viable claim there.
Drink that apple.
I think this crowd finds John Moxley's antics right now a little bit comedic and hilarious. And Neil Diamond Cutter is bleeding.
All right, Neil.
And this is wonderful.
Up. And Neil Diamond Cutter actually took that shot.
Neil Diamond Cutter finally shot
that he has consumed in this match.
Finally with a...
And the guy that's giving out the shots just took one of his own. That's awesome.
Finally with a little bit of intestinal fortitude.
Look at Neil Diamond Cutter's back.
I'm so happy.
This is... Moxley super kicked the chair and then... Oh! Suplex Cutter right on the ground. That was a snap suplex.
These fans in Bellevue might have it, but they really should fear for their safety right now. Believe Neil Diamond Cutter has AIDS.
You know how it goes. If the action looks like it's coming your way, it probably is.
I will take this fight what the hell I want, because I am the greatest wrestler that ever walked the face of the planet. You understand that? How dare you approach me with your tie and your terrible haircut? I'll kill you then.
I'm going to have to agree with the terrible haircut comment.
For once, I believe John Moxley has uttered true words.
What is happening to Devin Cutter?
Now, there's one thing that we have not seen yet, and I mean, it's the name of the match. I want to see a perfect plex. I want to see a Hennig plex right now. I demand a Kurt Hennig perfect plex. Give me a perfect plex.
Could happen. Oh! And he just moonsaulted glass. Not a human. Broke
Neil
glass.
Is a moron. He didn't even turn around to see if his opponent was still on the mat.
That was
what a freaking idiot.
He looked pretty stupid there. I'll go with you on that. More shots. More shots for Mox.
Now I know that men
just nuts.
Men like myself and you.
He's gonna puke on him. I'm sorry. I think that's what's gonna happen. He's gonna puke on him.
I would enjoy that.
Oh no. Airplane spin. How can that man stand? He's
vomiting. He's vomiting right now.
He's throwing up.
He is vomiting in the ring.
I think he is throwing up while doing an airplane spin. That was highly disgusting.
I demand that the ring be cleaned up before my presence enters the ring.
I killed the band with my band.
Don't tell me. Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
He's too wasted. The alcohol was his downfall.
I hate Neil Diamond Cutter.
And he didn't even use the perfect plex. I don't know. Give it up for both of these men. That was some serious stuff right there.
Neil Diamond Cutter. Damn it. I hate this. John Moxley is garbage. I hate him. I'm no longer a fan of John Moxley. Neil Diamond Cutter should be deceased and buried 6 feet under as we speak.
Didn't you had your shot last month to do that, I think. And didn't you say he beat you?
Erroneous.
He beat you.
Erroneous.
I believe you said he beat you.
You have no proof. It's just pure speculation.
I'm guessing they have it on camera. Moxley, I think, is just now becoming aware that he was in a match tonight and he, in fact, lost that match.
I hate John Moxley. Now that he's so drunk, maybe he can go get with one of these ugly rats that sell the concessions. I hate him.
Why would he want to find a rat? Wouldn't he want to rather find a girl or something?
There's more to the story.
How dare you disobey me? I'm the emperor of the world.
If John Moxley vomits on me, I quit IWA Mid South.
Please, vomit on Matt Cage for the benefit of all humankind.
I'd like to take some of your ladies home tonight, but they're fucking pigs.
Moxley has retrieved the tall boy he entered the ring with. I don't think he had finished it yet. I don't think he's even saying words at this point.
I believe that's pig Latin.
Possible. Drunken.
Smart Mark video. They're smart. Do you know when I went to college? I didn't. Because they didn't even want to have to deal. I am a genius.
John Moxley, right, Moxley is coming out of his britches, video. Nick Brubaker.
I am the most. I am.
And what flag is that on his tights?
He's coming out of his pants. This is just... This is terrible. This is an embarrassment.
Yeah, his pants aren't on anymore. That's a true statement.
I anxiously await the next round of this tournament.
Donovan McNabb should never have been traded.
As do I.
He gets no respect. Rush Limbaugh. Best from the right wing and the left wing. Two NFC title games. He produces, and he never raped a woman, and he never gets respect. The Philadelphia Eagles are full of shit. McNabb!
Divisional playoffs come, the Washington Redskins. If I don't even, you'll find out in the playoffs. You'll find out in the playoffs, Eagles. I'll kill you, Teddy.
The stipulation.
I don't know how you could possibly name this. There's barbed wire draped over the ring. It is tied over the ring, multiple rows of it. They have to step over it just to move.
Now, and reoccurring question for you. Have you been in a barbed wire
match? I don't know how many times I have to say this, but I have not been.
Have you been in a bull rope match?
No, that I have not. I've been in a strap match, that I have.
Okay, it's very similar. The rules, I believe, in this match are touch all four corners. But more importantly in this match, Ron Mathis in the green trunks, that is one hell of a wedgie.
That I was going to point it out, but you beat me to it. You beat me to it, Matt. That wedgie, I mean, he's got a lot of stuff crammed into those tights. He's jiggly. He's jiggly.
Now all of us can be blessed with the genes that you have, Mr. Brubaker.
I am known as the Golden God.
The Golden God?
Yes.
Are you golden, like, golden... I'm not
You've
sure.
You've seen the golden tan.
I have seen the tan.
You're seeing the golden locks of hair.
I also have a pretty decent tan myself.
And I've, that's not a
Oh my god.
Oh no. That's...
Well, I guess if you want to get over an IWA, you chop the living hell out of your opponent.
Yeah, that's what I hear, and that's what I see now. That's a real... Uh-oh. They're going to trip over that barbed wire. Oh! Right on the barbed wire!
Flapjack
and
right in the mammary glands!
He proceeds to rub it in his forehead. That's sick.
Now, I know the IWA Mid-South crowd...
Now, Mathis, running to the outside. Not... Hey... I would do the same thing. He just had barbed wire in his face.
The IWA Mid-South crowd might be a little bit unfamiliar with Brian Gott. And I have seen Brian Gott before. I have not seen Ron Mathis. I'm not all too familiar with Ron Mathis, but I do know that Brian Gott is quite the talented youngster.
Okay.
He has a bright future in the business.
All right.
And there's one way to make a name for yourself. And in the first ever Prince of the Deathmatch tournament, this has definitely got to count.
Yeah, that'd definitely be a step in the right direction. Oh, God. No! Oh, no, Mathis, oh.
Now, I believe that is a door.
Oh, that is a door covered in barbed wire, slammed on a man's, oh, now he's laid the barbed wire door.
Sentonic.
No.
Oh, God.
That is real, folks. The blood is beginning to pour from Mathis's back. Folks, this is gruesome.
Now, I know that the ad encourages young people at home watching to not try this at home.
That was a kick straight to the groin by Mathis, and I cannot say I blame him. Hip toss!
Oh, God!
That is just sick.
Brian Gott screeching, yelling in pain.
Reason number 7,077,000 why I do not do these kind of matches. That, right there.
Now, do you not do this because you do not have a set of cojones as big as these two gentlemen in this match right now? Or is it because you do not want to?
It's because I have a brain that's bigger than these gentlemen's, apparently.
I understand. I see what you mean. I don't think anyone likes Ron Mathis. Why did he just quote Bob Holly and ask, how do you like me now? What is this? Both of these gentlemen busted wide open.
His hand was on the barbed wire when he stopped. His hand was on the barbed wire.
That is kind of brutal. And you need your hand. Both of these gentlemen are duct taped to the rope right now.
He's gonna choke him to death. Why'd you stop then? I thought he was gonna choke him to death. He had me believing for a second that he was going to.
Are you sure he said that he was going to choke him to death? Because I didn't make that out.
He said to death, and then he's beaten with a cowbell.
I've got a fever, and the only prescription is more cowbell. Christopher Walken, 1999 or 2000, I'm not sure.
Love it. However, I don't think God is loving it in this moment.
I don't believe that God wants more cowbell. I think he would like less.
He's feeling that tap. He's been having barbed wire.
Son of a goo.
That was one hell of a forearm.
Comes into IWA, throwing rolling elbows around. Now I've got to think of something else to do this evening. This is might be it.
Oh, you better get to thinking then, Matt.
Ron Mathis with a near fall on Brian Gott. This young man comes into IWA and they look to make a future for themselves.
No! Uh-oh!
Oh! Backdrop driver right on the barbed wire. Go for the cover, Brian. Go for the cover. Go for the cover, you moron. You have the match won.
Hey. Got two. He's two more. Oh! Rope racked his balls, did a front flip, landed on barbed wire.
I guess he figured that the first low blow did not work, so he would use the rope-assisted low blow to make a statement for the second time.
After the choke.
Maybe this time he'll actually choke him to death.
No, he doesn't like choking for that long, just for a little bit, then he lets go.
I'm not sure the man is very intense, and he is definitely bringing it right now. But if I was him, I would have already touched all four corners, and I would be backstage having a margarita. Nick Brubaker, there is fewer things in this life that I enjoy than white people chopping the hell out of each other.
I don't care what color you are. I just want to see people chop the shit out of each other.
You don't care what race, creed, or color they are?
No. Never mind, that would have been racist. I can't say that.
It's okay, I hate African-American people. Oh, God!
I believe he caught barbed wire. Yes, and he's pinning him on the barbed wire. Oh!
Brian Gott better realize that Ron Mathis will slam him in that barbed wire as many times as it takes to become victorious in this tournament.
What is it going to take? They've landed on the barbed wire multiple times. I don't think either of these men even feel pain. And if they do, I think they like it.
Well, we already saw one crazy gentleman out here by the name of Marcus Crane. Ron Mathis could be touching all four corners right now.
Yeah. I think these men are beginning to just hate each other. Forget the purpose of the match. They just want to beat the living hell out of each other. Oh my God.
Let me take a moment to quote Dusty Rhodes here. They are bringing out the plunder, baby.
Accurate statement. The plunder has
what is he doing?
Oh no. Oh! It's a little slappy.
German suplex of sorts into the barbed wire, and Ron Mathis is tangled up, but Brian Gott should be going for all four corners right now. He could be going for the four corners. He could be going for a pinfall.
How did he kick out?
If Brian Gott would have covered him 10 seconds beforehand, the match might be over right now.
You just know everything, don't you, Matt?
I like to think so.
Hold on. What's he going for?
Oh, my God!
Landed on the cowbell and the barbed wire and the door.
That is a way to rupture a disc in your lower lumbar region.
You're killing me with the terminology.
Don't you patronize me, Nick Brubaker.
I don't even know what that means.
These Bellevue fans, who I can't stand, coming to their feet. Perfect plex.
The perfect plex. Wrong match. Still effective. One. Oh, and he's still coming.
Kurt Hennig would hate him right now. What a piece of garbage.
I swear that move used to work in the early 90s.
But Brian Gott bringing him up to the top rope. Chopped him right in the nipple. I wish John Moxley would have taken off.
Back to the nipples. You need
yes,
to stop him.
I'm sorry. I don't have a nipple fetish. For all you listening, I do not have a nipple fetish. But I do have a fetish with watching people destroy each other for my pleasure. And that's what's going on right now.
Vicious headbutts. Front suplex.
Oh! Falcon Arrow off the top rope. This has got to be it.
Yes. Mercifully, this match is over.
These two gentlemen.
Wait.
These two gentlemen.
Wait a second. I thought they had a
These two gentlemen came into IWA Mid South, their first ever appearances to my knowledge, and they brought it. And Ron Mathis becomes.
I don't know if they'll ever be able to come back.
Well, they've got to come back. They've got to find a way because Ron Mathis is into the next round of this tournament.
How is he going to continue? They can't get the rope off of him.
Brian Gott got dropped on his head. He could be unconscious right now.
Pretty sure.
We might need some help in the ring. He got dropped right on his head.
Unless he regains consciousness, then he'll just pick right back up.
He could be paralyzed. And these troglodytes in the crowd not even showing them proper respect. They could at least come to their feet and give them a round of applause.
These what?
Troglodytes.
I'm not even gonna ask.
Bellevue Troglodytes.
I think you made that up.
I told you I was from here, you little punk!
This is Bellevue, Illinois. This is the IWA Mid South. This is the Prince of the Deathmatch Tournament. What do you think, my broadcast colleague? We got OMG, Kyle Threat, and the returning Simon Says in a barefoot thumbtack spectacular. I've never seen anything like this in my life. What do you think?
I think that contrary to your sounding like Dusty Rhodes, I'm joined by Jon Moxley right now. But I also think this is a very dangerous match.
I've witnessed one barefoot thumbtacks match in my life, and it was one of the grossest, sickest spectacles I've ever seen.
That is what I'm expecting.
Disgusting. And we'll see if this can live up to the expectations of previous barefoot thumbtacks.
But Jon Moxley, neither one of you two have ever participated in one of these. I've done five of these. And it takes a man with a set of balls or one tough bitch in Mickey Knuckles' taste to do this match.
What does it feel like when thumbtacks are going into your foot like that, walking across them like hot coals? It's like something out of a nightmare.
Well, remember, you know, Mox, you got to remember, most of the nerve endings, you have the most nerve endings in your feet, in the bottom of your feet. So
it hurts like a bitch.
Excruciating pain left and right each time they go in there.
That was a serious shot.
I did one of these with Madman Pondo in IWA East Coast, and my feet were purple the next day. I had to stay an extra day, and nobody wants to stay an extra day in West Virginia.
Walking through the tacks.
Oh, that's going to be even worse, because the ring gives away. If he's got tacks on the floor.
Sailing through the air.
These men don't have shoes
like a bird.
Similar to a bird. Kyle Threat firing this crowd up.
The littlest thing hurts. And then when they're gonna start getting glass involved in this thing, this is a first round match.
I don't know if I want to be here.
One of these men have to advance.
But will they
what
be
kind
able
of sick, demented bastard thought up these stipulations?
I think it might be the guy.
You're responsible, aren't you? Admit it. You're responsible for this chaos. Oh, my God. Stepping right into tax, like dipping his feet in cold water. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh, the... Oh, it's just, oh,
no.
Oh, there's a light tube in the ring, and men have bare feet.
Those screams are as real as it gets.
Oh, my.
Threat, kicking thumbtacks out of his feet.
And are we going to make this any worse?
I can feel it.
How bad do these men want to be called Prince of the Deathmatch? They're willing to go through this kind of torture. Torture!
John Moxley, the first time me and Man Pondo did this match, Pondo, 10 minutes into this match, said, Ian, this fucking match sucks.
Oh. Definitely sucks.
Simple yet accurate description of the torture these men are putting themselves through right now.
What are they going to do with this
life? What kind of a strategy? What kind of a strategy do you bring to a barefoot thumbtacks? Do you just dive right in? Do you try and avoid them? Do you try to... You don't want to be outside of the ring because it hurts worse? So what kind of a... things do you think about when you're in a situation like this? This is going to be high risk. Pedigree position. Oh. Thank God for both guys. They missed that light tube. What sort of strategy to bring into a match like this?
Oh, no.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Oh, gee. And the sound reverberates through the halls of the Bellevue Plaza, the light tube breaking. Swords of glass flying in the air like lightning in a black night.
Oh, I don't know what that means, but Simon Says is busted open.
And now we have a staple gun involved in the match. What? Kyle Threat, you sick son of a bitch. Oh, God.
Oh, no. Don't you.
Every hand in the Bellevue Plaza went to the owner's respective mouths. This crowd is sickened. Yet they love it.
Don't do it. Please.
That was like witnessing a car wreck.
2 inches away from my face. Car wreck. Yes, exactly. Like
I think Ian Rotten got some glass in his eye. We were too close. Too close for comfort
too
there.
Close for comfort.
Did they put bulb wire up?
Kyle Threat is bleeding. Glass. Kyle Threat
took the night off.
My God, there is no nights off in the Prince of the Deathmatch tournament. This is where princes and kings are born. Oh, Simon Says.
He's freaking out.
It looks like he just...
That's internal.
There is crimson mask kind of juice going on here, John Moxley.
The blood is flowing like red wine in Bellevue Plaza. Simon Says going for a vertical three.
Real.
What kind of words can describe a vertical suplex from the outside of the ring in? Onto thumbtacks, onto shards of glass. Ought to be called the Prince of the Deathmatch to wear the crown. Kyle Threat says no. He says no, damn it. No, damn it, Simon Says. I'm not going to let you take this away from me. The sport of kings has been reduced to this type of butchery. Thumbtacks.
He can't even take a step. He can't take steps without pain.
About 8 years ago, after doing one of these matches, the great Nick Bockwinkel came up to me and said, "Kid, I'm glad I didn't have to earn my living that way."
Let those words sink in. Let those words sink in, the time and age we live in.
What's he going for?
Both these men are bleeding like pigs. Oh, gee, looks like he's in so much threat. Is in so much pain.
They have to be in serious pain.
My God.
They're thumbtacks.
These men are putting themselves through this kind of horrible abuse. Ought to be called Prince of the Deathmatch. For what, $500, $750 paydays? This is, what kind of these guys doing for the love of the sport, for the competition, hungry athletes? I mean, the winner of this will only be guaranteed only a few grand. And Look at the blood. Look at the blood.
It's
like, oh, it's like a mop of blood was wringed out. Puddles of blood on the floor.
He is filling a sock up.
This is intriguing me.
With thumbtacks. I don't know what you could do with this.
A sock is being filled.
Is he
going to
put it on his foot? Is he going to is he going to dress Kyle Threat?
Some sort of swinging weapon, perhaps.
Oh, or
Simon
swinging
weapon. Is battling through
he can't even move his
pain feet. That comes from a place I can't even imagine.
Oh! Sock full of thumbtacks to the dome.
How bad do these guys want it? Being dragged across the thumbtacks.
That's just sick.
Like a mule cart. Men are quite literally walking
knee
on
drop
pins and
right
needles.
To the skull. Further busting Kyle Threat open. How can he even climb the ropes?
Retreating to the relative safety of the top rope. Ah, the grimacing pain going on in Simon Says right now. You can read it on his face.
Oh,
impact on the frog splash. Oh.
That's the worst besides defeat.
Oh. Mercifully, please. No.
What is he going to take?
Somebody stop. This
there's still life left for Kyle Threat.
Hideous.
Oh. Kyle Threat is not out of this. Oh.
You hear that punch?
I'm entranced. I'm entranced by the combat that we're witnessing. Kicking full force with bare feet, thumbtacks and glass. Simon Says looked like he was shocked with a taser.
No, don't do this.
Pain flowing through his body like electricity. Just screaming in pain. Screaming in pain. We're about to find out how bad. Just how bad Simon Says and Kyle Threat want this tournament. We're not even out of the first round, guys.
That's what I was just going to bring up. How is either man going to make it to the second round to put up a
I'm not even sure the crowd's going to make it through this tournament.
You can't really put much behind him punches because he can't step. All your power when you throw a punch comes from your hips.
Exactly. You can't kick off the heel.
Oh, no.
Oh God. Oh, God. Oh! Driving right through the glass. Oh, power slam. Oh, merciful. Merciful Christ.
Wow.
A sickening display of disgusting, horrible deathmatch wrestling like I've very rarely have seen.
I have never seen a display of violence like
these
that
men.
Before.
Listen to this crowd. Bellevue races to his feet. These sick redneck sons of bitches. Love it. They love every second of it. They eat this up. Oh, Kyle Threat is in quite a bit of pain. Oh, God. Kyle Threat will move on. At what price?
You fucking day and age.
At what price does Kyle Threat move on?
He's fucking dead. Kyle Threat remains.
Blood loss.
Who's the real threat around here?
Nerve-ending damage. An amount of pain withstood that I can't even imagine. Barefooted, limps to the dressing room.
Champion, the IWA Mid South, World Light Heavyweight Championship, International.
ever in professional wrestling there was such a thing as a hometown advantage. Ryan Phoenix has it right now here in Bellevue, Illinois, his hometown, filled with Ryan Phoenix supporters. Tonight he's defending the world light heavyweight title against J.C. Bailey, returning recently to IWA Mid-South after a long absence. One of the most important, biggest stars in IWA Mid-South's history, the experienced J.C. Bailey, who is schooling Ryan Phoenix right now. Twisting him up into a pretzel, arm dragging him around the ring. And Ryan Phoenix better figure something out quick. Because let's face it, he didn't want to get embarrassed in front of his hometown audience. Ryan Phoenix, one of the new stars of this new generation of IWA Mid-South competitors. One of the most popular and successful. Oh, quick O'Connor roll out of the headlock. Nice. And an arm drag of his own. Drives J.C. Bailey hard to the mat. One of the most successful and popular of the new generation of IWA Mid-South wrestlers. And he's looking to parlay all that momentum into a successful title defense here against the very experienced, very wily, and popular in his own right with hardcore IWA Mid-South fans, J.C. Bailey.
Taking his sweet time right now, though. Get back in the ring.
So J.C. Bailey bringing the mass experience advantage into this match.
Shut up!
As soon as Phoenix got a little momentum going, J.C. Bailey bailed right to the floor. And a little bit of head games from the veteran, J.C. Bailey. A decade of successful competition with J.C. Bailey. Off the ropes, hard with a tackle. And a little bit of extra there. High leapfrog. Oh, J.C. Bailey, a step ahead, hooking the rope. Phoenix connects with a drop kick, and J.C. Bailey flees. Uh-oh. Phoenix on the move. Suicide plunger to the floor. Right in the lap of his hometown supporters in Bellevue, Illinois. And we're going to see how nasty these guys get. We're at the Prince of the Death matches, and we have seen nasty already with that first round. Yeah, well, I mean, we would hope this would be a scientific, classy contest, but J.C. Bailey, you never know. You never know just how nasty it's going to get. Oh, and these guys fighting out under the bleachers. Tonight is just getting completely out of control all across the board. Throwing chairs out of the way. Up to five now. Double count out. Ryan Phoenix will walk away with his title. Is J.C. Bailey even aware of how close he is to letting this opportunity at a light heavyweight title slip away from him? Nasty knife edge chop. Referee's up to nine, and finally back in the ring. J.C. Bailey cognizant of the count. Now heads up to the top rope. Could go for the double stomp. Oh, he hits it this early. This could be it. We could have a new light heavyweight champion right now. Oh, Phoenix.
So close.
Gets that shoulder up.
Oh, the shirt's coming off.
J.C. Bailey getting pumped up now.
And he's checking with the shirt.
And he's going for the kill right now. He smells blood, even though this is the only match tonight that hasn't had any blood in it so far.
Crowd trying to get behind Ryan Phoenix.
Yeah, Ryan Phoenix, one of these guys who truly feeds off this audience, feeds off the love and the adulation of this crowd. These people have been with him from the beginning here in Bellevue. Looks backslide, that puts him right over to his feet. Swings, catches, right into a neck breaker. One step ahead is J.C. Bailey. Into the cover, all folded up. Phoenix still says no. Right now, Ryan Phoenix riding high as the light heavyweight champion in IWA Mid-South.
It's dangerously close. losing that with that last win.
And he's got a challenge ahead of him, JC Bailey, Irish whip. Boot to the gut. And a scrape of the boot right across the jaw of Ryan Phoenix.
Looks like he's out. No pin attempt by JC Bailey.
And JC Bailey looks like he's having a little fun messing with this crowd, these Ryan Phoenix fans. Another boot to the gut. Again with a scrape. This time Phoenix out of the way. Boot of his own. Into the suplex position. And high vertical stalling delayed suplex. Which way are we gonna go here? Straight down south. Into the cover quick. Deep cover. No. JC Bailey still slips out the back door with the left shoulder. And now it's the momentum on the side of Ryan Phoenix.
Snapmare.
Oh, leg lariat across the throat. JC Bailey, Ryan Phoenix, light heavyweight title. Ryan Phoenix remaining remarkably composed, despite all the head games, by the experience, the veteran, JC Bailey, who's on the reversal. Phoenix up to the top, new heads is in position.
Oh.
Fireman's carry.
Oh!
Ooh, drops him straight down. Nothing pretty about that landing, Ryan Phoenix. Now positioning Phoenix again, possibly another double stomp. If he hits, maybe this will do the trick. Ryan Phoenix looking hurt. Perhaps he was just playing possum. Oh! Senton splash.
Gotta be it. No! JC Bailey, a tenth of a second away.
And Phoenix still fighting through. Remaining composed. The game of human chess. The sport of kings. The light heavyweight title. We are in. You really have to be here live, people, to feel the intensity billowing out of this crowd. Heavy chop.
Phoenix says no,
quite literally.
Oh! Phoenix, fires back forth.
Like he's been hit with a shot of adrenaline. Fireman's carry, JC Bailey at the back door. Another boot to the gut, small package. Oh, now Phoenix on top. Phoenix gets it. Wait, what just happened there?
Wait a second, who won?
Let's see what the referees call here.
I thought it was Phoenix. There seems to be some confusion.
Small package. Who was on top? Still light heavyweight champion, Ryan Phoenix. Crafty move by the far less experienced Ryan Phoenix. Flipping the small package. JC Bailey's own move turned against him. This crowd wants to see more of this action. We actually get a handshake. Great sportsmanship here on a night of gore and blood and filth and death. Ian Rotten
just called out.
Demands to start the match with Matt Cage. And I was like, team number one, we have Dan the Man at 127 mean fighting pounds. The undisputed king of IWA Mid South, Ian Rotten.
And Sal Tomasello.
I was trying to make out what's going on here. I really can't hear the talkings going on between these two. Anyway, and Sal Tomaselli, one of the most dominant IWA wrestlers of all time, a member of the Tomaselli Brothers, among the most dominant tag teams in IWA Mid-South history. A tough veteran, if there ever was one. On team number two, we have Matt Cage, a young up-and-coming rookie, who is now doing something with the referee, and it's not all that funny, so I'm just going to ignore it. And the Hooligans. Let's talk about the Hooligans. My favorite team. I've had my troubles with them in the past, but the Hooligans, my favorite team. They're both about 16 or 17, and they look like they're in their mid to late 40s.
That can't be
ugly, sweaty men hitting each other and clubbing and grunting, and hairy, ugly, sweaty men fighting. That's the kind of wrestling I grew up on, and that is what the Hooligans are, a throwback to today's before pleather pants and before quesadoras and bandanas and you know, hipanesas and all that, you know, bullshit. A time when ugly, large, sweaty men fought for pride. Clubbing. I said fought. Clubbing. Clubbing is what I'm talking about, Brubaker. I'm just going to pretend anything that's happened thus far in the match has not happened yet, and I'm just going to start the match from here. I call it up on Siam. Matt Cage in the wrist lock. He run, ever the crafty veteran, right into the eyes. Matt Cage took that pretty bad. He has no idea where he is right now. A thumb right in the cornea. His eyesight is completely disrupted. And the referee had to have been looking right at that. And I really don't see why Matt Cage has to argue this. The referee had to have seen that. And now this...
I believe that was a Samoan spike.
That absolutely has to be illegal.
Has to be.
A spike to the... There's three or four different possibilities of where that thumb could have gone. None of them even remotely legal or, I mean, pleasant in any way to speak about your experience.
No. I don't know. Where did
it's from Prince of the Death Matches.
Where did you learn that move? I don't think it's a death match.
I have a few ideas.
You want to share?
No.
Okay.
Later on, we'll talk about it. But
sounds good.
Not while the cameras are rolling. Here in Bellevue, Illinois.
The crowd is on fire.
The Prince of the Death Matches.
Which will be crowned later this evening. Currently, we're witnessing what looks like a fight between the referee and Matt Cage.
Oh. Matt Cage falling for the oldest trick in the book there. If he didn't come to some sort of term, some sort of agreement with this referee.
Doesn't look like he's having on good terms with his tag team partner.
He's never even going to be able to start this match with Inran. I call it an elbow tie. Another arm ringer. Inran. That strength. Inran like a bull elephant tugging on that arm.
I knew that was good.
Oh. He tries to thumb him in the eye. That's a little bit of payback. That gets deflected. Deflected. Larry Curly Moe style. And a thumb right back in the eye. Matt Cage, who's now cowering in the corner. Perhaps tagging one of the Hooligans in. All right. Hooligan number one. Hooligan number one. He's now going to try his luck, taking on the bull elephant, the king of death matches. And a crafty bottom wrist lock takeover. That is expertise. In Rotten. He's not just a one-trick pony, ladies and gentlemen. This man, shoulders down. Hooligan number one, better keep those shoulders off the mat. And team, this whole team has absolutely been schooled by Ian Rotten right now. They're not being able to put together any offense, and now he's getting tied up like a pretzel by Ian Rotten.
What do we call this here?
Ian Rotten looking like Billy Robinson here tonight.
Uh-oh.
And now a little bit of Wet Willy. And that's very disrespectful. And I came in here with high hopes for the Hooligans. I love the Hooligans. My favorite tag team. on the indies. And these ugly, sweaty men. And, you know, they're not just not doing any, they're not dishing out any of the punishment like I'd hope, Baker, I must say. Ian Rotten making a mockery of the hooligans. Now, Ian Rotten's child is next to me now, and he's sitting right next to me and is holding my microphone stand. It's making me very uncomfortable. Go away, child. Go away, child. Tell him about the hooligans. He wants to say nothing, folks. Ian Rotten in the ring right now.
Test of strength possible here.
Ian Rotten wrestling in front of a small child, risking his life. Oh! Flipped over. Yeah, get the child out. We got business.
Back to serious business. Okay. Ian Rotten has firm control of this match right
Attack
now.
There.
Firm control. Who's getting in? Rock, paper, scissors.
And
classic.
Team number two over here is having no luck putting together any kind of meaningful offense.
They're doing rock, paper, scissors too.
What is this?
I'm hard enough to figure it out.
For God's sakes.
Of course the hooligans cannot figure
Get
out.
Get a man in the ring.
All they do is beat people up. And they're not doing a good job of that.
And Sal Tomaselli has retreated. Has retreated underneath the ring. And has now popped up on the far side to deliver a slap right to the buttocks of Matt Cage. And this is a sad fucking display, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, the steel chairs in the ring. All right, we're going to get nasty. Oh, and it's out just as quickly as I opened my mouth. Ooh, Matt Cage being a challenge. He says, Ian Rotten, you're the king of hardcore. I brought a chair to the ring. What do you got? Matt Cage is just arguing with everybody in the world and just having no success at putting together anything that even resembles a start to a match. Ian Rotten.
Firm control.
A headlock takeover. Matt Cage wriggles out. I'm glad we're not keeping score, ladies and gentlemen, because right now it's about 57-1. Matt Cage finally gets, and just as I opened my mouth, he was bitten, or his leg hair was pulled. What just happened?
I think he was bit. I can't tell.
Ian Rotten. Not above biting a man in the leg. And here we are. IWA Mid South Prince of the Deathmatches. Oh! Shot right to the gut and a side headlock firmly planted on Matt Cage. Perhaps they've been playing a little bit of possum this whole time, do you think? Oh, Ian Rotten on the switch. Now into a front face lock and the go behind. And back into a top wrist lock. And the heel trip down to the mat, shoulders down. Matt Cage just got owned. And trying to pull hair on Ian Rotten. That's going to be a tough task. That is a tall order to try and pull hair.
And the
curly armpit hair of Matt Cage. Oh my God! Vicious palm strikes to the face. That'll give you a cauliflower ear. I had a bit of a row with the man in the steam room. Gave him a cauliflower ear. Bully! Oh, shots right to the face. Matt Cage is being absolutely owned here. Like a walrus. A walrus sunning himself on the rocks. Ian Rotten.
I've never seen that, but I'm sure you're right.
Lays on top. Lays on top Matt Cage. Mercifully, Sal Tomaselli hangs in. Oh my God! And oh,
punishment is not over for Matt Cage.
As hard a chop as you'll ever hear. Oh, and a nasty drop kick right to the back. Business is picking up here.
Puts him into the buckle.
Oh, face first hard.
Oh, release German.
Getting the Sonny Waller's treatment was a lot better for Nick. Oh, Matt Page is just getting lit up. Sal Tomaselli has had enough. Sal Tomaselli has had enough. On the turnaround, Matt Cage. Perhaps we've lit a fire underneath this man, finally. Don't celebrate too soon, my man. Back suplex, folds him in half. Dan the Man, the resident superhero. Oh, like a fly swatter. But a nasty fly swatter on the whip. Dan the Man reversed.
Head scissors.
Whoa! Tilt to whirl head scissors. All right, Hooligan number.
That's number one.
Number one again. Number two is number two. You have to be in this match. Boom, hard swing.
Drop kick
connects. Dan the Man. Dan the Man looks for the cover, can't get it. Back in control. Ah, now the Hooligans will take young Dan the Man to school. Oh, what a hard knife edge right across that chest of young, small, frail, cowardly Dan the Man. Oh, and a headbutt, nice. I love the Hooligans. This is vintage Hooligans. I'm a fan.
Vintage Hooligans. Matt Cage re-enters the match.
That's how good they are.
He hasn't had too much success in this match so far. Let's see if you can.
Yeah, they're not really dancing with what brung them right now. Oh, nice leg lariat. Oh, Dan the Man might be out. He just fell in a sack of potatoes. Oh.
I thought he was that cold. Matt Cage going to town on Dan the Man's face.
The Hooligans haven't even broken much of a sweat. They are rather sweaty, so I mean they are sweating.
They are
perspirating. Yes, they are perspirating some, but not a lot. Oh, dangerously close to his own corner there, but brought right back into bad territory. And now Hooligan number two and number one and Matt Cage. That is a triple headbutt. That will scramble your brains. Ooh, nasty kick right into the spinal cord. Right into the chest cavity.
What?
And I don't believe what I just saw. That just happened, Mr. Brubaker. That just happened.
I think I just saw Hooligan number one do a moonsault.
Yeah, a standing moonsault. I can't even do that. I'm the greatest athlete in the world. Oh my God. No, almost a quick pinfall. The wraparound schoolboy pin. Oh, and Hooligan number one bringing him back. Number two. Bringing Dan the Man back into a neutral corner. Can't make the tag. And this will be their best chance of success. Isolating Dan the Man, who just got sandwiched in that corner.
Not happy
Hooligan,
with the speed of the
number
count.
Two, looking for a faster count there. Don't get frustrated. And now biting right in the head of Dan the Man. No remorse. No remorse from the Hooligans. Yes, this match quickly de-escalated into a sordid affair of biting and scratching and ball pulling. I'm sure there was something. There was something going on with. Oh.
Oh no.
Wheelbarrow into the bulldog. Dan the Man putting all his weight down. All 98, somewhere between 98 and 125 pounds down on the Hooligan. Couldn't get it. I've lost control of what's going on.
I think the referee might have lost control as well.
Hooligan number two. Methodical. Walks right into the foot. Hurricane run off the top rope.
Capitalize. He's going for, I think it was
no cover
roll.
No, a cover will do you no good right there. You are in Bad Street, USA. Wait, I can't believe I just said that. I'm a professional compensator. I'll say whatever the hell I want. I have a microphone, and you don't. So you will listen to every damn word I have to say. Beautiful butterfly suplex. And now into it. A tight front face lock. 15 grueling minutes later, here we are. And this crowd is being built to a fever pitch here in the Bellevue Plaza. Feeling every bit of pain Dan the Man feels, who's desperately trying to get to his corner. He's so close. Matt Gaetz is the referee distracted. Ian Rotten is there on the tag. I don't think the referee saw it. Hooligan number one is in all kinds of trouble. Referee says, I didn't see the tag.
That's the rules.
Referee says, Ian Rotten, I'm the law. I don't care who you are, Ian Rotten, says the referee. I'm the law, I'm the order, and you get the hell out of my ring. Oh my gosh. Spike DDT. Brubaker, did you see that boogie? It flew like a satellite out of the sky, landing directly on feet. My God. Now Matt Cage going into Sal Tomaselli, and quickly this is degenerating into a thuggish beating on this stand a man who was just eating all kinds of leather in that corner.
Matt Cage has some choice fingers for his opponents.
Oh, nasty cannonball in the corner. I think he hurt his own head on that. Right in the center of the ring. I don't think Dan the Man's gonna get up. Dan the Man. Dan the Man says, I will fight through this pain, hooligans. I will reach down deep into the pit of my stomach and summon everything I have left to make the tag to Ian Rotten and or Sal Tomaselli. The heart displayed by Dan the Man this evening is
barely able to stand.
It is breathtaking. The heart displayed by Dan the Man is inspirational. Fireman's carry.
Dan the Man reverses into a lumber blower.
The knees went right into the face of Matt Cage and popped him up like a Pop Tart popping out of a toaster.
Exactly like that.
And this could be the opening. Get that child away from me. This could be the opening. Dan the Man needs it. It is. Tag. It was seen. Sal Tomaselli is going to town with hard right hooks on the hooligans. And now number two off the Irish whip. Reverse. Sal Tomaselli catches the backdrop position and flips him around. Dumps him right on his head.
Oh, so close.
That match almost ended in the blink of an eye. Sal Tomaselli, hear the smack of the flesh, vicious forearms, vicious chops. Sal Tomaselli, all this built up, pent up frustration and rage as Dan the Man took a vicious ass kicking while he sat helpless on the corner. And look at hooligan number two, says, fuck you, Sal Tomaselli. I want a piece of you. Sal Tomaselli with the foot up. And a lariat. My God, he took his head off. That's all, no. Hooligan kicks out. It's going to take a lot more than that. Ian Rotten, the crafty veteran, strong as a bull elephant, the king of the hardcore, a man known for going through... Oh, sandwich in the corner. Uh-oh. Ian Rotten moving swiftly. Oh, my gosh.
Ian with words to Jason.
The agility of Ian Rotten displayed. He's 65 years old, ladies and gentlemen, and flies through the air. Superplex, power and glory. Oh, shoved off the top rope by Matt Cage. Ian Rotten out to find out what the hell just went on. A brawl ensuing on the outside of the ring right in front of us.
Hooligan number two.
Sal Tomaselli bounces off the post. The hooligans alone in the ring. 3-on-1 situation. Wheelbarrow. And an elbow and a DDT that was so sick, I don't even have words. Dan the Man's career may have just ended with a heart-stopping wheelbarrow DDT off the second rope. And this one is not over. The Hooligans living up to their billing, just causing all kinds of trouble. The bell is ringing.
Hooligan number one is coming
Hooligan number one has come back with some sort of pens or crayons.
Those are syringes.
Surgical syringes. What place do those have?
Where do you have a syringe?
What's going on? Don't do this. Don't do this, please. Ian Rodden. That man has a family. You son of a bitch. I defended you, Hooligans. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, please. I don't want to see this. I just don't want to see it anymore. I don't want to see it anymore. Ring the bell. Perhaps that will persuade them to stop. Ring the bell more. Oh, my God. Ow. Syringes. It's like an action. Oh, my God. I can't even believe what I'm seeing. Ian Rotten is being crucified. Sal Tomaselli is restrained and tied up. Dan, the man, may be dead. This is one of the saddest displays of poor sportsmanship I've ever seen. Syringes are hanging from the face of Ian Rotten. The man who gave us all an opportunity, who made us everything we are in the business today. This man has a family and kids and a mortgage. This man who gave us everything. This man who sacrificed his life so that we could achieve our dreams. And this is what you do to a Bam, you sons of bitches. You sons of bitches. JC Bailey.
Even with the heated words these men exchanged earlier, JC Bailey came to the ring to check on the safety
of Ian Rodden, teaching these young kids a lesson in wrestling. Is thrown around loosely. Dream matchup. But ladies and gentlemen, this is what you're witnessing right now.
a dream matchup, not just for the fans, but for Drake Younger. Childhood hero was Sabu. A man who patterned his style, his career, over the homicidal, suicidal, genocidal maniac known the world over as Sabu. And these men didn't waste any time. Like I said, Brubaker, this is Drake Younger's dream matchup.
And let's see how he fares against his childhood hero.
To go in the ring against a legend,
not many
such as Sabu, a guy who you inspired you to get into this sport. A guy who you thought about every day when you train, every time you step into the ring, every time you get into the car to go on a long drive, every time you're bleeding out of your head and feel like you're gonna pass out, every time you're too tired to go on. All the struggles, the trials and tribulations of the career of Drake Younger, you think about guys like Sabu.
He's going hold.
You wanna get to that level. You think, am I ever gonna get to that level? That's the kind of thing that motivates you. And here we are, Bellevue, Illinois, Prince of the Deathmatch is Drake Younger's dream matchup. Sabu missing on the swing, and Drake Younger connects with a lariat of his own, and another standoff. And these two look just as evenly matched up as we could have hoped.
Bellevue fans starting to get into it.
This is the kind of thing you live for. This is an opportunity for Drake Younger to step in the ring with a man he patterned his career after. A man who inspired him, who motivated him. A man whose legend he hoped he could live up to in carving out his own destiny, his own career. On the move, misses. Sabu springing off the ropes. Springboard tornado DDT. Sabu might have landed right on his elbow there. That was vintage Sabu. That was the kind of move Drake Younger used to watch on his television when he was a child. Camel clutch.
Trying to end it early.
What do we say? No!
Drake Younger's a tough mother.
This is an opportunity for Drake Younger to put Sabu down, to score a W. Believe me, being in the ring with Sabu is not enough for Drake Younger. A man I know well, a man I have spilled blood with. Here, elsewhere, around the world, a man I know better than my friends. Who's now being dumped in unceremoniously to the outside. Sabu and Drake Younger looking a little worse for wear here already. They tore right into each other right off the bat, and we're gonna spill right into the audience here. This is the match these people came to see. Not only this Prince of the Deathmatch tournament, but this match here. Drake Younger and Sabu, a dream matchup for the fans. Ooh, listen to that leather laying in. It's right here by us. Sabu, a master and innovator of chairs, of tables, of weapons. Throwing the chair.
Gets a chair of his own.
And Drake Younger just Sabu'd a chair into Sabu's head.
He Sabu'd the chair into Sabu
himself. Is that more poetic justice than that? Sabu reeling. These guys just tooth and nail from the get-go. Like I said, being in the ring with Sabu is not enough for Drake Younger. He needs to score the victory.
What would a victory
to score a victory over a legend, over one of his heroes, what will that do for the confidence of Drake Younger? One of the top independent wrestlers in the world. World traveled. World-class competitor.
Locks in the camera.
Successful everywhere he's ever been. A staple of IWA over the past few years.
Drake trying to get the crowd behind him. These people in Bellevue are starting to get up.
Twice now, he's escaped that camel clutch from the ropes. And let's talk about Sabu. Homicidal, suicidal, genocidal. He didn't get that name by mistake.
No, sir.
He is tearing right into Drake Younger, going for the throat, going for the chairs. Drake Younger off of the flying forearm. Deceptively explosive and quick and agile is Drake Younger. And a big headbutt, jumping up for a little extra momentum. And another one right to the now bald head of Sabu, not supporting those famous blocks. Drake Younger on the charge, hard clothesline in the corner. Snapmare back out to the center. And a snap of the neck. Sabu's neck, 10 years ago, was broken. Well, 6 or 7 years ago, was broken in the ring with the crippled Chris Benoit. Landed a scene I don't even need to describe. Everybody's seen it over and over again. Dumped directly on the top of his dome. One of the nastiest, most horrifying accidents we've ever seen in wrestling. Broke his neck. And I'm sure Drake Young is not looking to end the career of his hero here, but that's always got to be on your mind when looking to score a victory. That's an area you want to target. It's got to be something that Sabu's constant. Every time Sabu has stepped into the ring for the past 6 or 7 years, that's got to be on his mind. And if you start attacking that neck, you know, that's definitely a way to throw Sabu off his game, to make him go defensive. And here's Sabu, has a chair draped across his chest. Drake Younger, and Sabu was just waiting for the opportunity. Soon as Drake Younger left his feet off the middle rope, Sabu shot that chair up like a cannon. Oh my, Sabu has a skewer. Is that a wooden skewer, Brewbreaker?
I think it's an ice pick.
That is a wooden skewer, and he just split Drake Younger open very quickly, looking every bit like his legend.
Look at the look,
like his uncle, the legend, Sheik, and Drake Younger instantly with the crimson mask. I mean, it's nothing he's not used to, but now the dynamic of the match has changed. Now there's blood loss. Sabu pointing to the heavens. Vintage Sabu. I don't think he's pointing to the heavens in hope of getting some help, because he looks firmly in control of this matchup. Drake Younger had to know that Sabu was willing to take it to this level. Like, homicidal, suicidal, genocidal. He doesn't care if he's in Bellevue, Illinois, and Madison Square Garden, in the back alley, in his living room with his wife. He will take the fight to the extreme. Oh, and that was a skewer right to the throat. That is extremely dangerous. Oh, a shot, an up shot right to the throat. Drake Younger looks like he's heaving for breath. And this matchup could end if Sabu is taking away the breath, blocking the DDT. Side headlock. Oh, back suplex right on the chair. Looking for some momentum.
Drake needed that. I think there's a crowd behind him here. He might have a shot at getting back in this match.
People have been asking for years, does Sabu feel pain? Does he feel fear? We may just find out. Has he ever faced anybody as hungry as Drake Younger is tonight? He tastes blood, and he likes it. A shot right to the back. Drake Younger, never shown any fear in his life. Never shown any remorse in his life.
A stomp on the chair onto Sabu's head.
And, to reiterate, that surgically repaired neck, as long ago as it may have been, it's still fresh in the mind of anybody who's ever seen that footage. And now into a Muda Lock, pulling up, bridging back, pulling up on the neck. Sabu quickly out. Sabu has a wound right on the back of his head from that chair. And now Drake Younger is going to gladly introduce more hardware into this matchup. Another chair being brought into the ring. And it's got to be like looking into a mirror. Sabu's so innovative, he's created a whole generation of wrestlers using the same tactics as he innovated years ago in Japan and in ECW.
Driving the edge of that chair into Sabu's back.
Tactics that Drake Younger has used to great success and carving his own success and his own career. And now Sabu, seated in that chair in a great amount of pain, and Drake Younger is taking a huge risk. Senton misses. Younger flattened that chair.
Oh my God. Another steel chair.
Sabu.
Vincent Sabu, double jump lariat. Drake Younger just fell right on top of that chair.
Maybe collapse.
Cognizant aware, he is in the ring.
Still able to get his feet.
Drape that leg across the top rope, and Sabu, right, kicking right at that leg that was open. Kicking right in the hand. Leg drop.
That's a little payback for that stop
with the chair. I hate to keep saying it, but vintage Sabu. This is the kind of stuff Drake Younger knew everything to expect tonight. I mean, you gotta know, what is it in Drake's mind? And here we go. And Drake Younger knew it was coming. The double jump, the triple jump moonsault, was able to trip up Sabu before he even was able to get to the ropes. You gotta know. Oh! Sit out Death Valley driver on the chairs. And Sabu kicked out.
What else can Drake Younger do here?
You gotta know that Drake Younger knows every move in Sabu's playbook.
I think he's
out
of moves for himself. What is he gonna do here? Oh no.
Oh.
Sabu returns to drop to one of his own.
Oh! And Drake Younger just got Sabu'd. In his literal sense. Oh! Nasty leg drop off the ropes with the chair. Now, Drake Younger as a seated chin lock with the chair. The pressure on the spine.
He doesn't want to lose.
And Drake Younger, he had to give up. He had no choice. The Sabu would never have let that hold go. Sabu. So expertly placed that chair across it. And now continuing the attack. Sabu, no respect for the man. And even I have to disagree with this. No respect for a man who's one of his biggest fans now attacking the ref. Sabu is crazy.
He's going to work.
Ian Rotten now ringside. He's about to get attacked with a skewer.
JC Bailey.
Drake Younger, JC in the ring. JC Bailey,
Kyle Threat.
The whole IWA locker room running out. And you want to talk about a maniac. Lots of guys act crazy. But for God's sake, Sabu is every bit. He shows up every bit the homicidal maniac we've seen. Drake Younger lost a lot of blood. And now Sabu continuing the attack.
Stop!
I'm not gonna knock Drake Younger one bit. Oh, and now a standoff here with Ian Rotten and Sabu. My God, what a place. Throws a chair at the fucking ref. My God. Love it or hate it, a bravado performance by Sabu. Drake Younger, I'm not gonna knock him one bit. He had no choice. He's got a career to think about. He's got big stuff on the horizon. He's a young competitor. He came at Sabu fearless. But in that predicament he was in, he had no choice but to submit. That was a smart thing to do. But I think Sabu, as if this match couldn't get any more personal.
I don't care. It's like hardly stand right now. I've been through the fight of my life. And Sabu, you are a man that I have the utmost respect for. You paved the way for crazy asses like us to have a job. You see, Sabu, all that is out the door right now.
Oh, Sabu's back out.
You might have stabbed me.
This is dangerous.
I'm scared of you. I'll never be scared of you, Sabu. And I'll tell you what, you want to bring weapons into play? Ian, I want you to listen right now, too. First week in June, we got a little tournament called the King of the Deathmatches.
Oh, shit.
Sabu,
Oh, shit.
Right now, even though I lost.
It's getting pretty,
I don't think pretty, I like
pretty, pretty fucking close.
Go ahead and kill me right here. I don't care. I want trouble with Sabu. I am putting you on blast right now. I'm going to challenge you to your match, a table match, right here in Bellevue. Take a match in 5 minutes.
What is Sabu's response going to be?
Will Sabu accept?
Drake Younger just challenged Sabu. The
never known Sabu
the
to
innovator of the table.
Oh no.
To a tables match. At King of the Death Match.
John, I don't care. I hate your guts too. But Sabu, cut me in for this match. I swear to God. King of the Death. If I gotta die, I'm gonna put him through a table, John.
Drake Younger just looked me in the eye. Crazy.
The look
bloody.
In his eye was
insane. Possessed
both of those
and
guys
told me if he has to die to do it, he will put Sabu through a table.
Tell you what, King of the Death Match is going to be a crazy night.
Put it in, we're going to see what Ian Rotten has
give
to say.
Uh-oh.
Here we are, 11 p.m. Central Time, Bellevue, Illinois, Bellevue Plaza, round number two, Prince of the Deathmatch, two hungry young 25 years old and younger Deathmatch competitors, Neil, Diamond Cutter, and Kyle Threat. And this match has horrible barbed wire pits somewhere going on outside the ring. And we have high-flying, fast-paced, ducking and running action that ends in a high kick
this
across the head. There's still some splintering wood in the ring that Kyle Threat's going to use to his advantage here. Here we go, the semifinals. Kyle Threat defeated John Moxley in a drunken death match in round number one.
Neil Diamond.
Excuse me. Neil Diamond Cutter defeated one John Moxley
in a drunken
in the opening round. Kyle Threat defeated Simon Sayers. And now here we are in round number two. Yep. Both these men,
with
the worst for wear, to say the least. Is that what's going on in the center of the ring? I thought it was splintery wood.
It's an unlucky 13 match. The winner is the first man that can get 7 fish hooks into his opponent's body.
Seven.
But it's an unlucky 13. I don't get it.
We'll call it, you know what? I'll bet it's called an unlucky 7. Did you read the flyer? Unlucky 7.
We're renaming it right.
Fish hooks.
Oh.
Textbook. Rage Dojo arm drag. Kyle Threat, trained by the American Kickboxer. One of the greatest technical wrestlers in independent wrestling history. And there's nothing technical
about a fish hook.
In the traditional sense of the word about a fish hook. I don't even have words to describe the kind of sick weirdness about digging a fish hook into the bicep of another man.
Yeah.
And make sure Smart Mark Video, you get these fish hooks on camera.
Right.
Because from my vantage point, I can't even see, but I can hear the screams and agony of Neil Diamond Cutter.
Oh, he's got 3 fish hooks in him now.
Kyle Threat, the score is 3-0.
Yeah, to nothing. Kyle Threat has the
in favor of Kyle Threat. Brian Phoenix, you successfully defended your light heavyweight title against AC Bailey tonight. You got to be feeling pretty good.
Yeah.
And now you can kind of sit back and kick back and watch the rest of this spectacle unfold. It dropped hard all the way on the top rope to the floor, Kyle Threat. Neil Diamond Cutter.
I think he found some change in the middle of the ring.
He's got Neil.
Oh, American Rana on the outside.
American Rana flips OMG right over onto the floor. And how do you feel about what we just saw? Drake Younger and Sabu putting on one of the most intense matches I've ever witnessed live in my life. Drake Younger bleeding coagulated plasma like a stuck pig. And speaking of bleeding like a pig, I believe we have a cheese grater being put to use on the face of Kyle Threat by one Neil Diamond Cutter.
A cheese grater in an unlucky 7 match.
It doesn't get much more hideous than that. Whoa.
Whoa!
Holy! Whoa! Gigantic cat-like flip, avoiding the chairs, rolling to relative safety.
You got to figure both these guys lost a lot of blood tonight.
Yeah, both guys got to be on wobbly legs already. They say that women weaken legs. I don't think either of these guys get laid much. But losing pints upon pints of blood in the first round of the match, of the tournament, will weaken your legs.
I mean, he's got redder hair than
that. I'm still shocked from what we just saw. I've been numb. I've been numbed. This night of brutal brutality. Sickening sickness.
4-0,
yeah. Filthy filth.
Gargling.
Disgusting disgust.
Definitely.
Blood. Glass. Barbed wire. Fish hooks. Thumbtacks. Cheese grills. Sweat. Tears. Pain. Desire.
You're not
hearts.
Any words for me. None.
You say what?
You used the whole dictionary. A lot of it. Anyway.
I've seen so much.
I understand.
Gore this evening that I've been numb.
And a lot of jack.
From what we just saw of Drake and Sabu, I guess. This is a qualifier.
Drake and Sabu.
Think about the winner of this tournament is getting himself into. The winner of this tournament. We're only in the semifinals. We've only just begun. What these guys are going through, just for a shot.
Oh! A rolling senton into the
strike.
Neil Diamond Cutter.
Down the center of the lane.
Back of the head. Oh! That's disgusting.
What words do you have to describe a fish hook being placed, being dug into?
The fans are sadistic.
Skin.
Pierce his ear. Pierce's
yeah,
eye.
See, these fans are sick, inbred, possibly. You're from Bellevue. I'm sorry. You know what? I'm gonna rescind some of my remarks.
Yep.
Just so that we can keep this, you know, kosher between us. What? Describe to me. All right, you're from Bellevue. Describe to me the psyche of a fan. Hard suplex on the floor.
I won 3 eighth grade championship basketball games in this gym.
Oh, well. So a lot of history in this building for you tonight. The eighth grade basketball championship.
I just kept
and the IWA junior heavyweight championship. All won and defended here in the Bellevue Plaza. Describe to me, Ryan Phoenix, the psyche of these sick bastards in Bellevue who come out in droves to see the Prince of the Deathmatch, to see the King of the Deathmatch in June. And like I was saying, these guys
in the school,
these eight bastards, sick men, are putting themselves through this torture just for a chance to compete in the King of the Deathmatch tournament. And once they get there, they got to deal with guys like Drake Younger, Sabu, the Necro Butcher, who will be returning here next week. Another big announcement by Ian Rodden. Kyle Fracht.
Oh.
Huge guillotine leg drop off the top rope across the head of Neil Diamond Cutter.
And he's got another fissure.
Oh, okay. And the score now. Kyle Fracht has 5 fish hooks. He's only 2 away.
Shit.
American kickboxer would be sickened if he knew the kind of things that his student was doing this evening. A senton, driving the air. Get that child away from me. Driving the air out of Neil Diamond Cutter. Double underhook off the top. Lands back on his feet. Back dropped hard back into the turnbuckle. Now he's got a hold of a fish hook again. And the score will now be, if he can get it in him. How do you even judge?
It takes a pretty sick person.
5-3.
Another man's body with a fish hook.
The referee says 5. Can we get some kind of a scoreboard? Some kind of system of counting these fish hooks? 5-3. Kyle Fred. Kyle Fred's got 5. A double stomp.
Split leg moonsault.
Split leg and moonsault.
Yeah,
I mean, I would think you'd want to get this match over as quickly as possible and save yourself for the finals. Look, take as little risk as possible. Get those fish hooks in, get them, and get out. Easier said than done. Go for another fish hook, Diamond. Diamond Cutter, go for another fish hook.
I think he said...
Look at this floor. Just pools of blood all over this floor. From Sabu, Drake Younger, and everyone else here this evening. What a display, this Prince of the Deathmatch. Ooh. Air raid crash. Hard on the back and the neck and the head of Neil Diamond Cutter. And now here we go. 6. Did he get it? Did he get it? No.
It's
sweaty and bloody. Those little wiry fish hooks have to be hard to maneuver. And here we go. Kyle Fracht, 1 fish hook away from victory. Strange sentence to say, even stranger to witness in person. I'm in Bellevue. I don't even know what's going on right now. It's 6-4. I'm so confused. Every bit as confused as you are, fans. Why are we doing this? What's going on? What the hell is going on? Going for a superplex. Blocked. Neil Diamond Cutter. Guillotine leg drop of his own. Looking to score some points back. Can he take the offensive?
Smart Mark.
Oh, Kyle Fracht. Just looks like he's in so much pain. Oh, that's gruesome. When you won the 8th grade basketball championship here in this building, did the intensity in the air hang quite as thick? Was it quite as strange and uncomfortable as it is here now? Uh-oh. Powerbomb. Powerbomb. Oh, from one side of the ring to the other. Kyle Threat. His head bounces off the canvas like a basketball in Ryan Phoenix's 8th grade championship. There is no pinfalls, but there is a 5th fishhook. Is that 6-5?
Six.
No, that ties it. That ties it. Excuse me. Next fishhook in the body wins this contest.
And goes on to the finals.
What the hell is going on? Somebody will go to the finals. Now the intensity being picked up. First one to score, fishhook wins.
It's like, you know, double jeopardy overtime and whatnot.
Oh, reversal.
Lariat in the
falls
corner.
In with the corner. Does either man have a fishhook in hand right now?
The crowd's in stunned
silence.
Hardy
in the corner again. And these guys just look spent from this whole evening. Kyle Threat participated in one of the most gory matches I've ever seen. Uh-oh. Up over the top. Fishhook in the neck. We have a winner. Neil Diamond Cutter. Neil Diamond Cutter. Number 7. Barely by the skin of his teeth. Unlucky 7 fishhook match. Hideous. Hideous display we've seen. And Neil Diamond Cutter by the skin of his cavity-ridden teeth survives and moves on to the finals to face the winner of Ron Mathis and
Marcus
C.
Show him up in the finals.
Sportsmanship. This has to be the finest sportsmanship I've ever seen in a fishhook gouging match.
All right, Robbie.
We will see Neil Diamond Cutter later this evening in the finals of the Prince of the Death match. Kyle Threat, you have to give it up for him. Bleeding like a pig. Gave it his all here tonight.
Oh,
Another semifinal match, Ron Mathis and Marcus Crane in a Caribbean spiderweb death match.
And Marcus Crane looking like Lady Gaga right now. I'm not sure what the deal is with that, but I'm thinking it'd be a hindrance to his wrestling abilities. Okay. What? I think he just threw up thumbtacks. What is happening? Double stop. Could it be over this quick? Oh, Mathis kicks out. Unorthodox tactics by Marcus Crane, to say the least.
Creepy motherfucker, man.
That creepy motherfucker.
Sorry, that's
hey, it's okay. That's what he is. Oh, no. Avoiding the barbed wire. Oh, but not the thumbtacks. Mathis picking up the Lady Gaga hat, spitting in it, and rubbing it in his face.
There's that screech out of Marcus Crane that makes everybody cringe.
Maybe if you could throw up some more thumbtacks, maybe.
Unique.
Oh,
that'll light your chest on fire.
We've seen a lot of those tonight. Forearms to match. Up.
Oh. He kicks the board.
Crane blocks it.
Back fist.
Hits him with a back slap.
A hurricane rana.
Almost in arms.
And this could be an early.
Oh my God!
Marcus Crane, much to the approval of these people.
Mathis, oh my God!
Oh my God! Marcus Crane just throws him out of the ring.
I think Mathis's arm was actually ripped open.
Wow.
His elbow pad remained caught. Oh, watch out!
Oh, I slip and slide on the floor.
They're getting close to us here, and I don't really like being close to this action.
The back of the leg of Mathis is cut wide open.
Just rubbing the barbed wire in his face. And I think that means he's enjoying it. What the hell was
just
that?
Just a weapon out of nowhere. It looks
is
like
that a tiki torch. That was a tiki torch.
Anything can happen.
Clubs to the back. Followed by a knee. Crane's reeling.
A little bit of wrestling in the middle of mayhem.
What's Mathis got in store here? Suplex. Crane blocks it.
Crane into the spider web.
What's over?
Into a spider web like we see in front of us.
Up, floats over, goes behind.
Oh shit!
Super kick.
Roadhouse. Oh, face first. A nice little Family Guy reference with the Roadhouse and into the spider web with glass and barbed wire. At a moment like that, to remember a line out of a sitcom is something else. That kid is creepy. But it was a great road.
They're still picking the barbed wire out of Crane's skin as we speak. Mathis comes in front of us here, still holding his wound from earlier.
Shoulder blade ripped open.
Multiple wounds on both of these men's bodies. Crane is wrapped in barbed wire as we speak. He can't get out. Mathis doesn't care. He's going to work on him anyway.
He's gonna beat him out of it.
Oh no, this is dangerous.
There's barbed wire and boards hanging from the ass of Marcus Crane. The kid's gonna shit blood for a week. This is insane.
Pure insanity.
The action scene at night is only
blood. I'm not kidding. He has cuts all over his body, both legs, his back, his arms, his face, his chest, everything. Crane still attached to the barbed wire, still attached, getting choked out. That sounded like a gunshot.
Caved his chest in. Mathis doesn't care what the fans want one more time. He's on his own agenda and not working by the hour.
Marcus Crane is not able to get detached from this barbed wire here.
And everybody has the same opinion around Mathis.
Marcus Crane might have broken free.
Like a vagina brand new, if you know what I mean. just busted open. Fish hook in the mouth.
Oh, the referee has finally gotten Marcus Crane out of the barbed wire.
And Marcus Crane is laughing.
That is insane. The man is insane.
Kick to the side.
Kicks! Kicks! More kicks. Kicks! More kicks!
Brain buster!
Oh! Falcaro on the thumbtack.
One, two. Marcus Crane gets his shoulder up.
The Falcon Arrow off the top rope is what put his opponent away earlier in the evening.
There's still life in Marcus Crane. Mathis's hand is
Crane
busted open.
Incredible balls. No homo.
Are you going to put that in the ring? Do you want a hand with that, Ron?
Light heavyweight champion Ryan Phoenix just helped Mathis.
I mean, let's get this in front of everybody.
It's a team effort here.
He wanted it in the ring, and I want to see it.
I want to see it, too.
This is crazy.
Actually, I don't know.
5 minutes gone by in the match.
How many?
5 minutes. Seems like an eternity.
Yes, this 5 minutes seems like an hour. And it's got to feel like an eternity to these individuals in the ring. Although I'm not sure if Marcus Crane even feels
Marcus Crane doesn't look like he's on rubber legs. Just getting torn up by Ron Mathis. Roaring elbow. Crane almost into the
elbow doesn't
spider
work.
Web.
Crane's reeling. Uh-oh.
Mathis going for the front suplex.
Oh!
And it's all over.
This sick nasty.
Done. Oh my God.
They are still picking the barbed wire and the pieces of glass out of out of Mathis's back now. Marcus Crane! Marcus Crane, stepping his game up.
Ready?
All right, Matt Cage, this is it.
The finals of the first ever Prince of the Deathmatch Tournament comes down to two men who are very, very familiar with each other. These two locking horns in an IWA ring before, back in December of 2009 in Litchfield, Illinois. Neil Diamond Cutter on the losing end of that match and on the losing end of this thumbtack bat battle right now.
God, this is disgusting. Those wiffle ball bats are covered in thumbtacks. Oh, to the head. Oh my God. Oh, that is insane.
Only Marcus Crane has a mind sadistic enough to do something like that to his opponent. He is perverse, he is psychotic, and he is downright filthy and disgusting. He will do anything it takes to win a match. And that's how he wound up here in the finals of this match. Nick Brubaker, have you ever been in an Ultimate X match?
No, that I have not been in.
Well, I don't think that either of these two men have been in a normal Ultimate X match, let alone something like this, an Ultimate X match with a barbed wire.
This is disgusting. The scene is disgusting.
But I tell you what, Neil Diamond Cutter has the brain of a pissant, and Marcus Crane is as sick as they come. These two will do whatever it takes to win this match. They are both stupid when it comes to what they do in the ring.
Oh! Oof.
Marcus Crane, as I said, will do anything it takes, hip-tossing his opponent into barbed wire.
Marcus Crane might have it here. All he has to do is climb the ladder, climb the ladder.
I said earlier in the evening that I wanted John Moxley to kill Neil Diamond Cutter. It was unsuccessful. I said that I wanted Kyle Threat to kill Neil Diamond Cutter. Unsuccessful. If Marcus Crane does not kill Neil Diamond Cutter tonight, I will be a very, very unhappy panda.
And he is landing on loose thumbtacks that fell off of those bats.
You know, I know from experience that landing in a few thumbtacks hurts worse than landing in a pile of them. And Neil Diamond Cutter is covered in them in his head, in his back.
Barbed wire coming into play early.
Marcus Crane, hell of a match last round with Ron Mathis.
They've both been through two hellacious matches. I don't know how either man is still standing, let alone fighting in yet another death match. To the crowd? No. Marcus Crane.
Oh, tidal wave off the ring apron. Neil Diamond Cutter, as I said, doing anything it'll take to win this match, busting out the tidal wave off the ring apron. Unorthodox and unique offense here from the little engine that could.
His forearms are vicious. Oh,
I hate
his arm. Oof.
And the
if
action.
I saw it correctly, that was a boot to the face of Neil Diamond Cutter. Oh no. Taking one of the light tubes that Neil brought out himself to use against him. This is going to be bad.
Marcus Crane.
They're going to be advising his. Oh! That's real.
Marcus Crane thrives in this environment. He thrives in sick, perverted pleasure. And right now he is grinding. If I could see that correctly, he is grinding the broken light tube into the head of Neil Diamond Cutter.
Oh, that's disgusting.
Marcus Crane came out here earlier in the evening. You can't tell right now, but what he had written on his chest was, please stop me. I don't want him to stop. I want him to murder Neil Diamond Cutter right now.
We know you do, man. No. Face first into the bleachers.
Oh, God, not. He did this to me. Oh! Marcus Crane learning wisely.
Chops.
Neil Diamond Cutter tried to do that to me last month. He was successful, but now.
Big senton onto the bleachers.
Did you know that Marcus Crane was trained by Chris Hero, a master of the senton?
I was aware.
He might not have the weight, but he damn sure drives it down with force.
What's Crane got? Oh, he's got barbed wire. As if there wasn't enough surrounding the ring. Oh!
You know, myself and Neil's two brothers, Devin and Mason, we were successful. We were victorious in our bout earlier this evening. And right now, I gotta tell you, if he follows it up and he makes the hooligans trio, what's going on here?
He's got the bat with multiple light tubes duct tape around the bat.
This cannot end well.
This is ridiculous.
Knock the bombs away. Oh, God. Oh, God. And they didn't break, Nick Brubaker. The light tubes did not break.
I didn't think that was even possible.
I believe the light tubes are stuck in Neil's arm.
Oh, no.
And he busted his own back open on that. Oh, he's going to try it again. He's going to senton him. Double stomp him.
The double stomp.
You know, we already have one member of the...
Marcus Crane.
We already had one member of the roster lose a nipple before. I think Marcus Crane just became the second.
I believe you're right there.
And maybe Neil...
He might have lost both.
Neil with this opening, the little bastard. Neil with this opening to climb and gain whatever's in that folder.
Whoever gets that...
The winner. The winner, I know. The winner of this match gains entry into Prince of Death and picks their first round opponent, if I recall correctly.
He's the king of the death match.
King of death, excuse me. Oh my God.
Barbed wire in a man's testicles.
Neil Diamond Cutter's vagina has got to be ripped open, Nick Brubaker. Yes, you heard me correctly. His vagina.
Oh.
And there goes Neil Diamond Cutter's pretty new little gear.
Come on, what do you got?
What a stain in the underwear of life Neil Diamond Cutter is.
Let's see what you got, boy.
Marcus Crane, sick, twisted, psychotic. Drop driver. Neil, I hate to say it, but he could have this match won. He could have this match won. But he's a stupid moron. He's an ignorant ignoramus. He's not going for the ladder. He's not climbing.
Oh, and the low blow from Marcus Crane.
Instead.
What's he got? That was a huge DDT under the thumbtacks.
Impalered like DDT by Marcus Crane.
The crowd's starting to rally.
Shades of Gangrel right here in IWA, Nick Brubaker. I don't believe so. Marcus Crane with the trash talk to Neil Diamond Cutter. Right now, he needs to double.
Trapped under the ladder.
Marcus Crane putting all that 166.6 pounds on the sternum of Neil Diamond Cutter, but the little retard is climbing.
Oh, that's real. That's a real, real nasty back shot. The pain.
Oh, that is not fair. That is my move. That is my move, Nick Brubaker.
Well. Your move was just performed by Neil Diamond Cutter. Might have just secured his victory here.
The little piece of garbage steals my move, and he's probably going to win the damn match. I hope he falls off. I hope he falls off the ladder and breaks his two front teeth and breaks his neck.
Oh! Vicious shot with the bat covered in thumbtacks. He broke the bat off.
He broke it across his back, and I hope he broke his spine. Oh, come on, you crazy moron. Climb the ladder. Win the match.
Someone give me this.
No!
The barbed wire is caught in the other barbed wire.
He gave up on it.
He gave up on it. A wise maneuver.
All right, fans.
But he's... Oh, why is he not climbing the ladder? Marcus Crane going for something double underhook. Oh, he just headbutted him right in the penis.
Devin Cutter has the Neil Diamond Cutter, my mistake.
Devin's the fat one.
Yep. Number two.
What is this little moron, this retard?
Oh! Those wire cutters directly to the forehead of Marcus Crane. What's he gonna do with this barbed wire here?
Why is Neil Diamond Cutter not deceased right now?
He's got too much heart. That's what he's known for. The big heart.
Apparently Marcus Crane, well, crazy like crazy bread here in Bellevue, Illinois.
I do enjoy Little Caesars.
One more time, these fans are perverted. Marcus Crane sounds like our ring announcer here tonight. Oh, shh. I won't repeat. A man in my class doesn't say words like that.
Don't say it.
Neil Diamond Cutter, you know, they say he's a diamond in the rough. And whatever he's doing right now looks like it's going to be a rough landing.
He is wrapping himself in barbed wire. This is something that yours surely would never do. Neil Diamond Cutter's insane! And so was that senton.
Not smart, yeah, go figure, you retard. You know what? Neil Diamond Cutter is such an idiot that he is not presently on the ladder right now, climbing for that shot at King of Death. If I was in his shoes, I would have already won the freaking match.
Matt Cage, you're not in his shoes. Uh-oh, what do we got here? More suplexes.
Ring Boosteroo! Now Marcus Crane has the opening, he has the opportunity. Make the most of it. Oh my God, rocking the ladder. Marcus Crane sent face first into the barbed wire. And now Neil has the opening. And if Neil wins, I swear to God, I might consider suicide on the way home.
And the world would smile.
I resent that comment. I resent that.
I didn't
get up,
that.
Marcus. Get up. Get up. Punch him in the tank. Do whatever you have to do. Win this match.
How's this?
These fans on their feet. These troglodytes cheering for their every breath, every move. This is not smart. An electric chair drop off
from
the ladder.
From the ladder. That was serious.
Well, you know what? Marcus Crane's pants say, fuck Bob Saget. Well, I say, fuck that. You'd never catch me in such a predicament. Marcus Crane needs to get to his feet. The man has thumbtacks in his head. He is bleeding. He has taken dumps into the barbed wire. He's taken bumps on the floor. He's done everything. He's made it this far. This kid needs to come to his feet, climb the ladder.
Exchange of forearms. Who's gonna get up? Crane's got the better. Nope. Neil's got the better. Oh!
Diamond Cutter.
There's that Diamond Cutter. It's in his damn name. And Marcus Crane just up.
The move doesn't even hurt that damn bad. Look at the retard move the ladder away from the contract. What an idiot. Oh God! Marcus Crane with a handful of clitoris.
You are ridiculous, Matt Cage. What's gonna happen here? Crane, if he could just turn around here, he'd be able to grab the, what's he doing? He's got something else in mind.
This is not smart. This is not smart. Marcus needs to jump, turn around, and jump and grab the contract.
Gouging his eye out. Oh.
Oh, he licked the blood. What a sick bastard.
What is this? What is happening?
No, don't do it.
What is this?
Oh,
what is
God.
He thinking?
This is not smart. Don't do it.
Oh,
my God. Mark my words, these two guys just made their freaking careers right now. but Marcus Crane still needs to get the contract.
The contract.
It's right there.
It's right behind both men. But
grab it, Marcus.
They're both too out of it to even realize what's going on.
They just destroyed it. They just destroyed this apparatus that was holding the barbed wire Ultimate X. The contract is right there. One of them, preferably Marcus Crane, needs to grab it. Grab it. Become the first ever Prince of the Deathmatch tournament winner.
Who's gonna get it? It's sitting right there. I think they figured it out.
Marcus Crane said that he was an agent of chaos. Well, I think we found that out firsthand right here tonight. These two are slugging it out.
Oh, and a headbutt. Oh! And he got it.
Damn.
Neil Diamond Cutter, much to the dismay of Matt Cade, Pat, and Marcus Crane. Just like Casey said, he is the first ever Prince of the Deathmatches.
I'm done. I quit. Hooligans have come out to congratulate their brother here.
And there's the bell for this matchup to continue. Coming in and joining me here on commentary, of course, the one and only undisputed king of hardcore commentary, Dave Brainsack. Welcome
king
back
of
to
hardcore
the
commentary. Hello, Axel Rotten.
Oh, I mean, you're working your ass off out there. Double, triple duty every night. Undisputed king of hardcore commentary. New moniker for you, my friend.
Ian Rotten and JC Bailey. Ian Rotten has stated that this will be the final confrontation between he and JC in the series of matches, and has vowed during this matchup to make JC Bailey say, "I quit," trying to teach him a lesson, trying to teach him that there is a point in time doing this hard-hitting, hardcore, brutal style of wrestling that you need to say that your career might be in jeopardy if you take too much punishment, if you allow your opponent to do too much to you and not give up and not quit during the course of a matchup. He said that JC Bailey has a tremendous future ahead of him in professional wrestling. He might be the next Ian Rotten, the next Axel Rotten, the next Madman Pondo, but in order to get there, he needs to conserve his strength, his body, and allow himself to have a career past the age of 25.
Well, as I made light earlier before when you joined in the commentary, the kid just turned 20 years old.
Yeah.
I mean, and he's been through some brutal beatings at the young age of 20. I mean, some guys haven't done that in their whole career, and this kid's still fighting. And, you know, to be in the ring with a guy like Ian and going toe for toe, you know, it builds character, builds heart. But, I mean, at what point and at what cost for heart? I mean, there's only so much. At the end of the day, heart doesn't help you get up out of bed because your back's broke or your legs are broke or you got 38 stitches in your forehead. Sometimes the smarter man lives to fight another day. And I don't know if JC Bailey is going to be the smarter man. And at this pace, he's not going to be the smarter man because he's going to be crippled in a wheelchair.
And we'll see if Ian Rotten is able to teach JC Bailey. Bailey is has many training influences, the likes of Tracy Smothers, Chris Hero, Ian Rotten, trying to teach JC Bailey what it takes to be a good professional wrestler. And the mental game is just as important as the physical game. You need to realize in the back of your head, will I be able to get up out of bed next weekend to compete in another matchup? And if JC Bailey refuses to submit, refuses to give up, and realize that he needs to be able to stay in fighting shape like next weekend, he needs to be able to get into that ring in Highland, Indiana to go for the light heavyweight title against Sanjay Dutt and Nate Webb in a tables, ladders, and chairs match.
Absolutely.
If he takes, if this matchup here against Ian Rotten takes too much out of him, he might not have an opportunity to get that light heavyweight title back around his waist next weekend. And in order to do that, he needs to learn his lesson, learn to fight another day.
I'll tell you, if you think about it, Ian Rotten may be Sanjay Dutt and Nate Webb's greatest weapon. He's not even in the match. He could wear down this kid right here, and he may not live to fight another day. And let's figure out, finally, the cage coming into play. These two guys have been going at it, both fighting off different spots to get into the cage, and guys stopping, not getting into it. Now, finally, it looks like JC Bailey hits it head first once. And
now looking for a second time, face first, right into the steel mesh cage. Again, to win this contest, several ways. You can do it by pinfall, submission, knockout, or you can climb over the top or through the door and touch the floor, escaping from your opponent, touching the floor. After escaping the cage, we'll earn a victory in this matchup. 1 hour time limit, as they have battled in through several cities on the IWA stop. First show here in Olytic, first return show here in Olytic since 1999. Last month, they wrestled to a double pin. No winner in that matchup. Was a brutal war, available on Smart Mark Video. They had a tremendous matchup, which was mainly just straight wrestling in Scottsburg, Indiana at the Armory.
Oh my God.
Ian Rotten came up the winner of that one, but he was rammed right into the cage by JC that time. Both men have now met the steel cage.
And Bailey busted open, and I don't know if Ian was or not, but he hit that with full force.
And Bailey working over that head of Ian Rotten. If he was busted open, Bailey trying to make him bleed a little more, and now we see, yes, the forehead of Ian Rotten has been lacerated, and Bailey working over that on Ian Rotten right here, just raking his face right against the steel mesh cage.
You know, as much as we talk about JC Bailey, Ian Rotten is another one of those never-say-die competitors. And trust me, this just doesn't have to do with professional wrestling. This has to do with his real life. He's one of the most stubborn son of a bitches you're ever going to meet. So he doesn't want to give up. He doesn't want to tap out. So if this guy gets pinned or he gives up, you have pretty much broken his spirit and broken him in half to make the man do it. He's a very prideful competitor in that ring. He loves this business through and through. So it's going to be very difficult for him to continue to battle in these type of matches and Worthy got a submission on the line, because the last thing he wants to do is give up. He wants to make the fans of the IWA proud. He wants to make his family proud. And this is what he's built his life on, doing this type of matches better than I think anybody in the world does them, without doubt. Ian Rotten has brought IWA to new levels with doing these types of matches. My God.
Big running boot in the corner from Ian Rotten. He's getting a running start for a second, just kicking Bailey right in the side of the face. Of course, these two took on one another in the semifinals. Oh, big running senton right to the midsection of Bailey as he's sitting in the corner. They faced off in the semifinals of the King of the Deathmatches tournament this year. Bailey came up the winner of that matchup, involved a great deal of weapons. Two knees right down across the ribcage of J.C. Bailey.
And that's not J.C. Bailey doing it to Ian Rotten. That's a 250-pound guy dropping all his weight on the midsection.
Almost a 100-pound weight advantage for Ian Rotten in this matchup. Going to work on Bailey. Again, they took on one another in Scottsburg, Indiana, back in October. Ian Rotten came up the winner of that match when Bailey basically passed out during the course of the matchup and the referee counted him down. Rotten trying to make him submit, he wouldn't. They had a rematch in Scottsburg last night, falls count anywhere style. Bailey came up the winner of the rematch in Scottsburg with a ring post around the figure four leg lock around the ring post. And the pain of that caused Ian Rotten's shoulders to be pinned to the mat for a three count. Splitting matches in Scottsburg, Ian Rotten came up the winner of a matchup, falls count anywhere in Highland, Indiana, back a couple of weeks ago. So they've traded back and forth victories in this series of matches, but Ian Rotten has not made J.C. Bailey say that he's had enough and that he gives up.
I don't know if it's in the kid's vocabulary to say I give up. I think he wants to prove to the fans, when you look at him, he's not the most muscular man in the world. He's not the biggest competitor in the ring. And I'm not going to sit here and label you with every cliche that Bill Dundee's ever given you over the last 30 years, but I'll tell you this. This guy's got what it takes to do this type of wrestling, and that's something more than heart. It's a little bit of insanity. It's a little bit of, you know, unabashed will to do anything that it takes to get the job done. And you can't instill that in somebody. Either they were born with it, or they don't have it, and both of these guys have it. You can't teach that tenacity.
Big forearm right across the jaw of J.C. Bailey, and a kick from Ian Rotten has Bailey on his back in the center of the ring. Of course, J.C. Bailey made it to the finals of the 2003 King of the Death matches against Madman Pondo, which was held inside of a steel cage. Of course, that matchup had light tubes dangling from the top of the cage, so it didn't allow them to really do too much inside of the ring during that matchup. But Bailey, no stranger to cage matches. Ian Rotten having an epic cage match earlier in the year at the 300th event of the IWA Mid-South against Big Bad Bull Payne, came up the winner of that matchup. So really, it's anybody's ball game. Both of these men competing in this style of match
and
already during the year 2003.
Bailey taking Ian Rotten's arm and just using it like a cheese shredder on that cage, just back and forth.
Again, there's no real hatred between these two. There's no real feud. It's just a rivalry over who is the better man, and if Ian Rotten can teach J.C. Bailey, give him the tools necessary to have a lengthy career as a hardcore professional wrestler.
For some reason, those two just don't seem to fit well in a sentence, do they? Lengthy career.
Lengthy career and hardcore wrestler. No, not really.
But we shall see.
Bailey turns the tables on Rotten, has him backed in the corner. Series of forearm shots right to the jaw. Shoulder blocks now to the midsection, trying to soften up Ian Rotten, but he lifts the knee that time right into the jaw of Bailey. And Bailey again back down on the canvas on his back.
And for my money, still no decided advantage for either guy in this match. I mean,
not
it
yet.
Seems very even keeled.
Has gone back.
Ian said, open that door, I want out.
Can be won via escape, but J.C. Bailey sees Rotten making his way toward the door. Catches the leg
of
Rotten, but Rotten's got a steel chair in hand.
Hey, look out! He's going to hit him with it.
And now it looks like they might be fighting over control of that chair, as Bailey with a stop down onto the hand of Ian Rotten, and the cage door closes. Bailey now with that chair working over the arm and the shoulder region of Ian Rotten.
That much damaged shoulder of Ian Rotten. I think we all know that the several injuries. I mean, I know for a fact, stemming back to teaching Ian Rotten how to wrestle, like, back in 1990, that the fact that, you know, he had shoulder injuries from football and high school and throughout his pro career as a wrestler.
Rotten sent head first right into a steel chair, propped up between the second and the top rope of the ring.
And again, I think his shoulder got a piece of that one, too. Fans starting to rally behind the two gentlemen. We don't know exactly if they're rooting for one guy or the other, but the fans here enjoying themselves. Here goes JC.
Probably just a little bit split, but steel chair right across the head of Ian Rotten. Bailey letting go of the chair
basically
in mid-swing.
It at him. Going for a cover right here. We
and
get a one.
One by pinfall as well, but Ian Rotten kicks out just at the count of two. Again, we have two wrestlers also serving as referees on the show tonight in the American Kickboxer and Mickey Knuckles, a trainee of Ian Rotten, inside of the ring. Women's competitor, rookie in IWA Mid-South, but she knows how to lay down the law in this matchup. Referee out on the floor, Donnie Bowden, not a professional wrestler himself, just a referee. But Mickey Knuckles, as a wrestler, assigned to the inside of the steel cage duties for this contest. As now Ian Rotten driving the knee of Bailey into the chair last night in Scottsburg. Rotten focused the leg, focused on the knee of JC Bailey for the duration of that contest. Bailey not giving up last night. He could be going after that injury from just last night on Bailey. Again, the fact that he won't submit, won't say that he's had enough, could cost him this steel cage matchup tonight based on the events of last night in Scottsburg.
And last night there were some sickening thuds delivered by Ian Rotten to the leg of Bailey. And I talked to JC earlier in the dressing room, you know, and he told me he's nowhere near 100% for this. After that beating last night, you were there, you saw it. And to come back and do this steel cage match is absolutely incredible for both men after the beating they both took last night.
Rotten with a hold of Bailey's leg, trying to free himself from Rotten's clutch with kicks to the back. But Rotten strikes once again and looks to be in a little bit better shape than Bailey at this point. Fans rallying behind these athletes. Rotten back to a standing position as Bailey crawling into the corner. Rotten again with the steel chair in hand. Bailey back to his feet, but a chair shot right across his skull sends him right back down.
Oh my gosh. Wow.
Understatement, right?
Yeah, well, you know, I guess it's because I've been on the receiving end of enough of those, it just becomes numb literally to sit back and watch. Like, oh my God. The adrenaline's flowing when you're in there and you're wrestling, but to sit back and watch a guy get leveled in his head with that such brute force is absolutely incredible, and a testament to the different level of competitor we have here in IWA Mid-South Hardcore Wrestling, because these guys step it up not to the next level, but to the 10th level, and then every day give the people what they paid to see. I don't care if there's 20 people in the crowd or 2,000 people or 20,000. These guys go out each and every night and bust their asses to give people what they want to see. The best entertainment dollar in pro wrestling. For my money, these guys work their asses off.
Rotten with headbutts, delivering more punishment to the head of JC Bailey. After that chair shot, he might not know where he's at. Holding onto the hair of Bailey, keeping him at a standing position to deliver more headbutts. But hey, you're going to ram your head into someone else's, you're going to knock yourself a little silly as well.
And
Ian Rotten feeling the effects.
Doing the curly shuffle over there in the corner, not to make light of it, but he was knocked himself silly. He stooged himself.
And fans again, getting behind Bailey to work his way back up to his feet.
I think these fans respect the heart of this kid so much that, you know, it's just like that fighting will to win, the whole Rocky underdog theory where, you know, you look at this guy, you know, he doesn't look like much. He doesn't look like a big-time brawler, scrapper-type wrestler. But, man, when he puts it together in that ring, he is one of the most lethal competitors in hardcore wrestling. And I've seen him do it here. I've seen him do it in Combat Zone. I've seen him doing it all over the world. This kid can definitely handle his business. And Ian Rotten, it goes without saying, he knows what he's doing.
Several low blows from Ian Rotten to turn the tide of the match back into his favor.
I don't know if Bailey suggested the door be open, but it looks as if he did.
The door has been opened by a referee on the floor. If Bailey can inch his way toward the floor, he will become the winner of the matchup. But Rotten pulling him back away from the door, back into the ring. And no,
Rotten pulls Bailey back into the ring, and the cage door closes once again. Rotten trying to wear Bailey down and force a submission right here.
And this kid just will not give up. And I don't know if that's stupidity, intelligence, or just the lack to know better which one to do, but the kid will not give up.
Referee Mickey Knuckles asking JC, what do you say? Not giving up, even though in a world of hurt right now at the hands of his mentor, Ian Rotten.
Crossface.
And again, Rotten still with his legs wrapped around the body of Bailey, and again pulling back and landing another shot right to the bloodied face of JC Bailey.
I think to say even a world of hurt might be an understatement. The kid's in a universe of pain. I mean, it's like ridiculous the way these guys are giving it to each other.
Bailey rolled into a pinning predicament, but turns it around on Ian, grabs hold of the hands, trying to wear Ian down now.
And just punching him right in the back, trying to get those
15
hands.
15 minutes have elapsed in the matchup. 45 minutes remain in the time limit. For 15 minutes, these two have battled it out. Both men a bloody mess. But neither man with a decided advantage for very long. As Bailey now with a Fujiwara armbar on Rock.
Back into it. Now with that reverse Fujiwara on him, holding it kind of like a... if he bends that and tweaks that wrist just right, he can get a submission because there's no way to counter that type of maneuver.
Rolling Ian Rotten over, holding onto that arm, focusing on the body part. JC Bailey does have a game plan. He's going after the arm of Rotten, while Rotten seemingly going after that injured knee of Bailey from last night's matchup. Hammering down on the injured arm and shoulder region of Ian Rotten. Bailey trying to muster up the energy that he needs. Takes a breather for a second, comes out of the corner with a running drop kick right to that shoulder.
Calling for the door again is Ian.
Door has been opened, but Bailey sees Rotten making his way toward the door and pulling back on him. Shots right across the bloodied forehead of Ian Rotten. Cross faces from Bailey now. And the door closes once again. Bailey now climbing the cage. He could climb over the top and make his way to the floor and become the winner of the matchup in that fashion, if that's what he'd like. Ian Rotten with Bailey on his shoulders right now. Has him lifted up, maybe looking for a Rubik's Cube. Looks like Ian might be going for the Rubik's Cube right here. He does! Rubik's Cube from Ian Rotten. But he's had a lot of punishment dished out at the hands of JC Bailey and can't follow up with a cover. Tremendous maneuver, dropping Bailey right on his head from a shoulder position.
Unbelievable.
But not able to follow up just yet.
Ian back on his feet, off the ropes.
And a stomp right down onto the chest of Bailey. Double knees. Right down onto the young competitor, JC Bailey, known for the technical wrestling, known for light heavyweight wrestling, but also one of the most hardcore men here in the IWA Mid-South. Leg drop off the ropes from Rotten, right across his throat. Rotten goes for the cover, hook of the leg, one, two. But JC Bailey staying in the matchup. Looking for the support of the fans to get behind him, get that second win, make his way back to a standing position. Handful of hair by Rotten, setting Bailey up possibly for a pile driver, maybe a power bomb. Lifts Bailey up and drives his back right into the cage. But Bailey maneuvers his way out of it, trying to go for a sunset flip on Rotten. But Rotten grabs hold of the throat of Bailey, lifts him back up, drives him into the cage once again, and down goes Bailey face first to the canvas.
Both men feeling the effects of the steel cage.
Mickey Knuckles checking on the condition of Bailey. All of the punishment dished out from Rotten over the course of the past 24 hours, both in Scottsburg and here in Olytic, could be too much. Will this be the night that JC Bailey finally learns the lesson that Ian Rotten has been trying to teach him? To live to fight another day, as Ian Rotten, with a hold of the chin of JC Bailey, going for the submission right here, and the fans encouraging Bailey to stay in the matchup. Fighting back, several shots to the lacerated forehead of Ian Rotten. Headbutt, followed up punch, headbutt combination. Offense from Bailey, but it takes a lot out of him as well. Double count now administered by referee Mickey on both men.
Referee at four, it looks like Bailey's back up to his knees, elbows at the top of the head.
Trying to cause even more blood loss on his opponent, Ian Rotten. JC Bailey looking to take all of the energy out of Ian Rotten.
Right now, just trying to wear him down, keep his weight on him, choke him out.
Could win this matchup, be a knockout if he's able to do it.
Try to keep the oxygen from flowing to the head of Ian Rotten.
A one shot to the head of JC Bailey releases the hold, and Ian Rotten clutching his fist after delivering that hold, that blow to his opponent. These hard strikes that these wrestlers throw do just as much damage to themselves on impact as damage done to their opponent. Now just left-hand shots from Ian Rotten.
And look at the bloody fist. Ian Rotten on his hand is just...
With every blow inflicted, just bloodying his own hand in the process as well.
Beautiful three-quarter uppercut, kind of Bailey right on his backside in the ring.
A hard-fought battle. Ian Rotten going towards the cage door, asks for it to be open, but Bailey grabbing a hold of the ankle of Ian Rotten, twisting away right now. Mickey asking Ian Rotten if he wants to give it up as Bailey ties up the legs of Ian Rotten. Driving his knee right into the leg of Ian Rotten. He focused on the arm for a good portion of the match, now going after the leg as well. Solid shot from Ian Rotten. Yes, Rotten focused on Bailey's leg last night in Scottsburg, but when Bailey had control of the matchup, went after Ian Rotten's leg as well. Ultimately, it was the ring post figure four that earned Bailey the victory in the matchup last night. So Ian Rotten does have a weakened leg as well. So Bailey being very very smart and focusing on not one but two body parts so far in the match.
Well, I mean, Ian Rotten, his public record has been beat to death for the last 10, 12 years. And to pick a body part and to work on it is to pick apart an injured part of Ian Rotten, because there's not anything on the man that I believe is 100% of me, but he still works his ass off in there to forge ahead and try to do what he can to show these people here at IWA that he means what he's doing and believes 100% in the cause of this hardcore wrestling style that he so much believes in. Trying to get the chair, and he gets his hand on it.
Trying to get the chair, trying to roll this over. Rotten just throws the chair at Bailey. Looks like it might have connected with his nose on that.
Glancing blow, but if it's a glancing blow to the nose, it's enough to make you a little blurry-eyed for quite some time.
And it's still a big hunk of metal flying right at your
face. Absolutely.
Ian Rotten trying to choke out Bailey now. Make him pass out. Gain this victory with a knockout. Mickey Knuckles checking on Bailey's condition. Also asking, what do you say? Would you like to give it up? Will you submit? Rotten just telling Bailey, give it up, learn your lesson.
And JC's mother has now approached the ringside area, and Ian saying, look at your mother, don't make her cry, I can't believe this. And she's looking on rather intently at the ringside area.
Bailey has not given it up. He hasn't submitted. He's clearly in a world of hurt. Lots of blood loss. Worn down, but still fighting.
And look, Ian is basically taunting JC and putting him right in front of his mother, who's standing up now in the ringside area. I don't know if that's why. Is there any throwing in the towel on this thing? Mother. I mean,
she is not an authorized second. I think it is up to JC Bailey.
Does a mother really need to be an authorized second? I mean, I think she's an authorized second until the day he dies.
But I guess
that's
so.
An interesting situation if you think about it.
It's interesting to look into.
The parental rights, do they ever not apply in pro wrestling?
But perhaps Ian Rotten just showing JC Bailey that his mother would like him to live to fight another day. And maybe learn his lesson, give up. Don't force your mother to watch this punishment, but Bailey fighting back up, still going to work on the leg of Ian Rotten now.
That might have done nothing more than fire this youngster up and make him say, hey, you know, you want to go that way? No, I'm going to go this way, and I'm going to beat you, and I'm going to hurt you.
A strike to the face, to the hand, the injured hand of Ian Rotten once again. As Ian Rotten's leg tied up by J.C. Bailey, just grinding away at that knee. The knee pad has been pulled down.
And still going at it, a handful of hair, I think, by part of Ian. But
25 minutes have elapsed in the matchup. 35 remain in the time limit.
As these guys approach the 30-minute mark, there's no signs of slowing on either one. I mean, the fatigue and the wearing down of the loss of blood, yes, but both men tenacious as ever in this steel cage matchup.
Both men back to a standing position, but barely. Rotten lands a strike, but does more damage to that hand. Bailey ducks it. He collides with the steel with that hand, just clutching it in pain. But Bailey, right back to work on that leg, takes advantage of Ian Rotten being down on the canvas. Holding his hand, goes right back to work on the leg.
I'll tell you, you know, punching someone in the jaw can break your hand, but punching that steel fence, that's not going to give one bit.
And now the steel chair being used by Bailey on the hand, just stomping down on the chair with the hand viced in between the seat of the chair.
He may have broken a finger or two, if not the wrist or hand of Ian Rotten at this point. Still working on it.
And again, stomping down on Ian Rotten's hand, his shoulder, his hand, his leg, all victim of the onslaught of J.C. Bailey. And now a Greco-Roman knuckle lock just twisting away at that hand. Referee asking Ian Rotten now.
And listen to the listen to the yells, the blood-curdling pain this man is in. Unbelievable.
A hard-fought battle here in your main event, November 15th, 2003, in Olytic, Indiana. Double stomp now down onto the hands of Ian Rotten. This the main event of the second night of IWA Mid South's 7th anniversary weekend. For 7 years, we've brought wrestling fans of this region hard-hitting, hardcore professional wrestling. We look forward to several more years of action. If you live anywhere near this area or any of the towns that we run throughout the state of Indiana, make the trip. Come see it live and in person. If you're unable to make the trip, support us via Smart Mark Video as another forearm shot right to the jaw of J.C. Bailey.
Bailey almost hanging lifeless there between the first and second rope.
More headbutts from Rotten. Just exchanging them. Heads colliding right in the ring. Bailey lifeless, that second rope just holding him up in a seated position. And Ian Rotten looks to be out of it in a kneeling position. Oh, but he delivers another headbutt. It's incredible that neither man has said that he's had enough. Neither man has given it up. And more headbutts from Ian Rotten delivered to J.C. Bailey.
You know, and from this vantage point, they don't look like they're too devastating, but the headbutt, skull-on-skull contact is some of the most fierce thing you'll ever fear in anything. It just
and that's about
jars
the 25th, you. Maybe up to the 30th headbutt of the match thus far.
Oh, absolutely.
Back heel kick from Rotten, and again. Another kick from Rotten. Bailey out of it, slumped over in the corner. Another low blow from Ian Rotten.
And look at the face of Ian Rotten. Those headbutts he levied onto Bailey only did as much, probably equal, if not more damage to himself. Look at the blood flowing from his forehead. Just pounding and pounding at the skull of J.C. Bailey. Both men busted open even more due to
cage
those headbutts.
Cage door opened once again, but Bailey sees it and grabs hold of that chair right into the back of Ian Rotten, puts a stop to his potential escape. Bailey again with the chair, but a boot right to the midsection. This could be Ian Rotten's opportunity. The cage door is open. If he wants to try to get away or go back to Bailey and teach him that lesson he's been trying to teach him over the course of the past several months, ever since the King of the Death matches.
You know, I think that quote-unquote lesson may be Ian's downfall. He had a chance to walk out of that cage just right there.
Got a question whether or not, what means more to Ian Rotten right now? Teaching his student a lifelong lesson that he can employ over the years of his wrestling career, or gaining one victory in a matchup on one particular night?
Well, I know Ian Rotten because I instilled in him the same thing I believe he's trying to instill in J.C. Bailey, that one victory, one defeat, does not a career make. It backs in time. So the prolonged learning experience, if you will, is probably more important than that one victory or one loss at this
and
point.
That's probably why he had that cage door shut and went back to work on J.C. Bailey. These fans getting behind J.C. to make his way back to his feet.
30 minutes have elapsed in the match. 30 minutes remain in the time limit.
For a half hour, these two have beaten each other to a bloody pulp, literally, inside of the steel cage. Rotten with a hammerlock on J.C. Bailey, ramming his arm right into the steel cage. Rotten in control. Couldn't ask for that cage door to be open once again, but no, he's going after the steel chair.
He's trying to wield the chair, but he has a hard time holding it with his injured hands.
Chair driven right into the arm of Bailey now. Bailey going after Rotten's hand, shoulder, and leg, and now Ian Rotten going after the arm and the shoulder of Bailey as well.
Again, we're 30 minutes into this one, and without a doubt, you know, the injuries that these two gentlemen have laid out on one another, absolutely incredible.
Rotten now using the ropes for some leverage on this, wrapping the arm of Bailey around the second ring rope and pulling back on that arm, wearing Bailey down even more and looking for that submission.
Joining us in the commentary booth now for the remainder of what we don't know, could be another 30 minutes, Spider Nate Webb. Spider, welcome aboard.
It's Crackalack and Axel and Dave Prezak.
Hard-hitting matchup, Nate Webb, as Bailey to a standing position, and once again, even more headbutts. Divorce courts the arm of J.C. Bailey right there and goes right to work, looking for Bailey to say, I quit, looking for J.C. to give it up.
Well, I'll tell you, the kid hasn't given up, and he's not going to do it now. This is one of the most painful holds in professional wrestling. Everyone's poised. Referee in the ring is looking for it. The referee on the floor looking for this kid to tap out. Just not happening right now. I don't see him doing it. If he hasn't got to him yet, he's going to take him driving a bulldozer in here with a wrecking ball hanging from the ceiling to crush this kid to make him submit.
This match reminds me of 82, Axel, I tell you. But that's a different story.
Well, those were the days, Nate. Those were the days. And getting into this one, Prezak, like you said, we're 30 minutes old into this one, and these guys still going at it as if, you know, they duck under, excuse me. Oh, double knockdown.
Both men going for clotheslines at the very same time, and we are at a stalemate. Almost 33 minutes into this matchup, referee Mickey Knuckles applying a count on both wrestlers. Who will be able to make his way back to his feet and keep fighting?
And Nate, here's an interesting situation. You have the people coming up for him, but who are they for? We can't figure out the both guys. When they get a decided advantage, the crowd cheers for both of them. I think it's a mutual respect thing for both these guys going out there and working their asses off.
You get the veteran Ian Rotten against his student J.C. Bailey. J.C. will not tap out so far. And, you know, Ian will, well, I don't think he's going to be tapping out either.
Well, they're both throwing drop kicks at the very same time. And again, we're at a stalemate.
Now it's going to be a matter of who can get to their feet first. Maybe just one quick move could be the advantage that either man would need to get the pinfall or to make the other man tap out or escape from this point.
Rotten up on one knee now.
Screwing who can get to their feet first. Who can get to that chair first, man? Yeah.
Who can get through the door? Who can climb out of this cage? Who can score a pinfall? It's anybody's ball game right now. Rotten back on both feet. Bailey struggling to get back to his standing position. Big kick right to the chest into the arm of J.C. Bailey. Sends him right back down on his back.
Well, Nate, prior to you coming out here, the problem with the chair is the only one that would probably even serve an advantage for the chair would be J.C. because Ian's hand is so to the point that...
Oh! Big lariat as Ian Rotten comes charging out of the corner. Tremendous impact. And once again, Bailey goes crashing down.
We could have a fall right here.
Rotten with the cover. Two.
Kick out again.
And a strong kick out from JC Bailey, digging down deep for that energy.
As I was saying, I don't know if Ian can even grab the chair because I don't know if it's, I believe it's his right hand is incapacitated to the point that he can barely make a fist, so throwing punches out of the question. He tried earlier to swing the chair to no avail. If he's going to do it, he's going to pull one big one out of him, and that's all he may need. Irish whip in off.
Bailey's hitting the cage on those whips into the ropes. Russian leg sweep by Bailey, but he's very, very spent. Couldn't go for a cover immediately, but he finally does. Rotten gets that shoulder up. Ian Rotten still in the matchup. JC Bailey trying to bust out maneuvers, anything he can to try to gain the victory himself. Both men back up now. Bailey setting up Rotten now, maybe for a pile driver. Rotten trying to block it. Backdrops Bailey over the top. Bailey looking to sunset flip Rotten now. Has his shoulders down. Two. Only a two count for JC Bailey right there.
35 minutes have elapsed. 25 remain in the time limit.
35 minutes thus far in the contest. And it's still anyone's ball game. Rotten with the momentary advantage. Pulling JC back up to his feet. Backs him into the corner now. Shoulder block right to that shoulder of Bailey.
Again, I don't know if that's too smart because Ian himself has a very bad shoulder to be using it as a battering ram. Doesn't bode well for a man who has a bad shoulder.
And Rotten now. Butterflying the arms of Bailey. Lifts him up. Butterfly pile driver.
Oh, bye.
That could be it right there. If Rotten can roll over, he does. One, two, but Bailey with his foot on the bottom ring rope forces a break of the pinfall attempt.
How long did it take for these two to get bloody tonight?
They were bloodied within the first 5 minutes of the match, Nate Webb. Both men meeting the steel mesh cage early in the contest.
So let's take that factor for a minute. You have two guys that have been bleeding, you know,
for over a half hour.
For over 30 minutes, dare I say, the old cliche, profusely.
Rotten comes charging, Bailey able to move out of the way, and Rotten collides with the turnbuckle.
And Nate, you know as well as I do for being in the ring, you know, after staying length of bleeding, you get weak, you get disoriented.
Missile dropkick.
And you get missile dropkicked in the mouth.
Bailey rolling up Ian Rotten, going for a pitfall right here, but Rotten breaks up the pin attempt. Bailey landing that missile drop kick instead of trying to take the opportunity to climb over the top of this cage and reach the floor to gain the victory that way.
Not
and another
again.
Headbutt from Rotten. Bailey with a headbutt of his own.
Ah, reminds me of Texas Stadium. Was it 1982, 83, when we were on the show with the Junkyard Dog and he was doing this exact same thing.
Headbutt to the shoulder.
Shades of the Dog grabbing the cakes and he's going for another submission. No. Oh,
right.
My.
Wow. Grabbing hold of the arms of Bailey, trying to make him give it up right here.
Now, what you're looking at, Praise, like you got a double underhook with all of Rotten's weight on the back while he was pushing up with his feet. Tremendous amount of pressure on this youngster's back.
And pulling away on that injured arm of Bailey, but still not giving it up, still not submitting. A lot of heart, a lot of determination. But I don't know about a lot of common sense in young J.C. Bailey right now.
Well, I don't think common sense has ever been the staple of what IWA is for. I think realistically the time someone said, I'm going to jump off this balcony through 35 tables and 10,000 thumbtacks, logic went out the window. Right, Nate?
Ever since I saw a match with the 35 tables on fire with a bunch of tarantulas on the floor.
Oh, come on. They never did that. Going for the cover, Bailey. But Rotten gets his shoulder up. You'll notice Bailey resorting to the low blows. Rotten busted those out earlier in the matchup, trying to stay in the match. Turnabout is fair play as Rotten went low on, or excuse me, Bailey went low on Rotten before delivering that suplex and going for the pinfall.
I'm just saying this, Dave Prazak. I've seen some matches here in IWA, some death matches that have looked a lot like the items should be in the Temple of Doom.
That's true. Belly to back suplex for me and Rotten, and again, both men are down. Both men very worn out from this battle thus far, approaching the 40-minute mark. Referee applying a count on both wrestlers. Up to a count of four. Rotten on his knees. Bailey still face first down on the mat. Rotten rolls him over, going for a cover now. One, two, and Bailey kicks out at 2 3/4.
I would have to assume so far we'd probably had about 40 near falls in this match.
And about 40 headbutts as well.
Yeah, at least. So both men going for the win, as well as a number of submission holds. Instead of just trying to brutalize one another for the sake of violence, they're actually going out there trying to...
Bailey with a chin breaker after a boot to the midsection to his opponent. Rotten laying on his back. Bailey now looks to be going to the top rope. As Rotten still laying on his back.
He's going a little higher.
He's going higher. He's going all the way to the top of the steel cage. JC Bailey with Ian Rotten laid prone in the center of the ring. Comes charging down right on Ian Rotten. Makes contact. Able to go for the cover now. Hook of the leg. Shoulder of Ian Rotten up on that attempt. Mickey Knuckles right there to check on Ian Rotten. Maneuvers his shoulders off the canvas, putting weight down onto the shoulders now this time. And again, Rotten able to kick out, able to roll his shoulders off of the canvas. 40 minutes have elapsed in the match. 20 minutes remain in the time limit.
Well, we're into the over halfway point of this contest. 40 minutes gone.
Bailey throws the elbow pad down. Duck of the clothesline by Rotten. Boot to the midsection of Bailey. Double under hook DDT. The Rotten Rush. And once again, Ian Rotten not able to follow up with a cover right away because of the energy that he has spent throughout this matchup. Referee up to a count of four now. And five. Double count on both wrestlers.
And Mickey up to seven. We could have this called double knockout.
Up to a count of eight. And once again, exchanging forearms from a kneeling position. Bailey strikes once again. Rotten fires back with a punch, but again, that injured hand coming into play. Bailey lands a punch of his own, shaking out those fingers right now. And a kick right to the rib cage from Ian Rotten.
Both men fighting to regain some bit of composure and get to their feet at this point.
Both men back up. Spinning heel kick from Ian Rotten. Wonder where he's getting the energy to land maneuvers like that.
It reminds me of the late 80s classic with Leonard and Hagler, where Hagler would beat the guy down, beat him back, and here would come Leonard with a flurry, boom, boom, boom. Ian Rotten hitting with these flurries just enough to keep Bailey off balance.
I remember
Bailey asking for that cage.
I remember many spinning heel kicks by
Marvelous Marvin Hagler. Yeah.
Yeah, whatever.
Sugar Ray Leonard.
Bailey trying to inch his way toward that open door of the steel cage. They both land strikes at the very same time. Both men go crashing down.
Here we go again. It could
and
be a knockout.
Once again, referee Mickey Knuckles applying a count on both wrestlers. Both men landing solid punches at the same time. Both went crashing down. Referee up to a count of four and five. Anybody's ball game.
Almost I bet seven's next. There it is.
To a count of seven, which man will make his way back to his feet first? Eight.
Ain't gonna be no
rematch. To a count of nine, who will be able to stand? Ten.
That's it.
Mickey calling for the bell.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the call, 43 minutes, 14 seconds. Referee Mickey Knuckles has counted both men down.
I'm assuming in a situation like that, Nate, before we get an official decision, it's a draw.
A draw.
Well, that's just ducky.